Yeah, there, Emily said they were.
Academic at both the conference and national level. He's a physical and durable workhorse whose impact at Carroll has been tremendous. Dustin is a business administration major with management, marketing, and international business impetus. He's being escorted onto the field by his wife, Shelby Rinker, his parents, Wendy and Eric Hook, his grandparents, Gwen and Arvine Rinker, his aunt, Sherry Medley, his aunt, Sherry Petty, his uncle, John Brady, and his cousins, Ty and Michaela Medley, and Kristen Fedrish. Dustin also has a big group of fans that have made the long trip from central Idaho to watch his final regular season game. Ladies and gentlemen, Dustin Rinker! Our next senior is running back Coulter Rood from Green River, Wyoming. Coulter has been an unsung hero in the Carroll offense over the past 4 years. He has 393 career yards and 3 career touchdowns. Unfortunately, Coulter's senior season was cut short by an injury just 5 weeks into the season. His impact off the field has been big, however, and he has been an inspiration to his team. Coulter is a business major with a concentration on management with a minor in biology. He's being escorted onto the field by his parents, Shauna and Craig Rood, his sister, Cheyenne Rood, his grandma, Linda Rood, his grandma, Christy DeGrindle, and his grandpa, Frank Furlick. Ladies and gentlemen, Coulter Rood! Our next senior is right tackle Dominic Sal from Seattle, Washington. Dominic stepped into the starting role at right tackle this season, has been a big part of an offensive line that allows a Frontier Conference low 1.3 sacks per game and leads the way for the potent Carroll rushing attack. Dominic's major is history, political science, and social studies for secondary education. He's being escorted out of the field by his parents, Laura Sally and Steve Antash, and his brother, David Sally. Ladies and gentlemen, Dominic Sally. Our next senior is safety, Zachary David Saucedo from Watsonville, California. Zachary has been a big-time player on special teams for the Saints during his career. He's been one of the top kick coverage players on the Carroll roster. He's been a contributor in the Saints secondary with 38 career tackles and a pass breakup. Zachary is an education major. He's being escorted onto the field by his parents, Mark and Amy Saucedo, his brothers, Ryan and Garrett, and his grandparents, Manny and Zoe Saucedo. Ladies and gentlemen, Zachary Saucedo. Our next senior is linebacker Daniel Simmons from Whitefish, Montana. Daniel is a big part of the Carroll defense for 4 years. He has 74 career tackles, 5 sacks, and 6 tackles for loss. He had 26 tackles a year ago and already has 27 this season. He was named Academic All-Conference last year. He's a health and physical education major with a minor in psychology and secondary education. Daniel's being escorted by his parents, Sandy Kane and John Aldrich, Tracy and Jim Kane, also his sister Lori and his aunt Candace. Ladies and gentlemen, Daniel Simmons! Our final senior is running back Aaron Wirth. Aaron is the final member of the senior stable of running backs. His contributions haven't been obvious to Saints fans, but he helps his teammates on the practice field. Aaron is a health science major with a minor in public health. He's being escorted to the field by his parents, Brian and Penny Wirth, his grandma, Carol Wirth, and his uncle, Steve Wirth. Ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Wirth. We would also like to honor the 2 senior cheerleaders on this year's squad. Our first senior is Paige Kulick. Paige is a chemistry major and biology minor from Helena, Montana. Paige is being escorted onto the field by her mom, Nancy Kulick, her brother, Ryan Kulick, her grandma, Margie, her aunt, Casey, and cousin, Jessica. Ladies and gentlemen, Paige Kulick. Our second senior cheerleader is Erica Bosbeck. Erica is a health science major with a psychology minor from Helena, Montana. Erica is being escorted to the field by her parents, Mac and Carol Bosbeck, and her sister, Megan. Ladies and gentlemen, Erica Bosbeck. Saints fans, please put your hands together for your 2014 Senior Saints.
it just doesn't reach all the way here.
I mean, like, will the battery last?
It should last most of the game, but just in case, like, that happens.
Alright, so, Emily just told me that she needs another extension cord. Where do you want me to get that? Kevin, or talk to Steve.
Okay,
Kevin's not in his room, right?
Huh?
Kevin's not in his room.
I don't know, I just haven't been there with Kevin and his boss, man. So I don't know.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Nelson Stadium on the campus of Carroll College in Helena, Montana. Joe McMahon with you for more NAIA football. Glad you could join us this afternoon as the Carroll College Fighting Saints, second straight home game. They host today a team they haven't played in a while, about 37 years, actually. College of Idaho is in town to take on the Fighting Saints. The Yotes come in at 3-6 in the conference in their first year of with football back in their program in over 30 years. They are 3-6 in the conference, 4-6 overall. And this is their final game of the season. Last week, the Yotes took on Eastern Oregon and lost that game 45-21. But they started out the season really on a high note, winning four of their first five games. But it's been a downhill slide since there. Lots of underclassmen. For Carroll College, a little different story. Losing their first game out in Southern Oregon of the season, and then it's been eight straight victories for the Fighting Saints, who come into this contest at 8-1, ranked number two in the NAIA, and headed to the playoffs with a victory here this afternoon. They will have an opportunity to host a playoff game next week, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. Joe McMahon with you. Peter Young generally here to help me out, but he is elsewhere today. Be back with us hopefully next week. But looking forward to a great football game. College of Idaho, as I said, just a very, very young team, 79 freshmen on this team, listed on their roster. For Carroll, it's Senior Day, their last conference game here at home. They have 19 seniors that have been honored before the game. So, kickoff just moments away. A beautiful day in the capital city. No snow falling, snow on the ground, as you can see around the field. But the field appears to be in great shape, and no forecasting for snow today. The temperature will be about 13 degrees at kickoff, and it's the Fighting Saints against the Yotes from College of Idaho, Caldwell, Idaho. Here. I'm glad you could join us. We'll break away. When we come back, we'll take a look at the few more pregame activities. We'll talk a little bit about what do we anticipate, and it'll be kickoff time. We're back after this.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
Wow, it's a 2014 Ford Escape. Very sharp. EcoBoost, huh? That MPG will save some money. How about capability? Intelligent four-wheel drive? Perfect for our weather. Back here. Foot-activated liftgate. Oh, now that is smart. And now get up to $3,000 cash back on a new Escape with Sync and Sound. Or lease one for just $219 a month? It's the one for me. Reinvented for all, equipped for you, so you can go further. See your local Ford store today.
As a student, as an athlete, it is so important to stay focused.
When I'm not on the field, I'm in the classroom. When I'm not in the classroom, I'm in the woods.
So you have to focus and prioritize what's important.
The choices I make on a day-to-day basis are huge. Not using tobacco, it all benefits who I am and who I am as a basketball player.
When you step on the mat, it's only you and another person, and making healthy choices is the first step.
Without making those healthy choices, I can be held back in my performance and I can hurt my team.
It's very important how the community sees you. I'm focused on a tobacco-free generation.
Thank you.
Back at Nelson Stadium, the national anthem performed, and we are about set to go. The captains will meet the center field. The officials are heading out right now. Like I said, welcome to Nelson Stadium, Carroll College, Helena, Montana. The Fighting Saints ranked number two in the most recent NAIA poll. And for the Fighting Saints, it's been a great year for them. They're, as I mentioned, they lost their first game out in Southern Oregon, but it's been nothing but victories since then. And they trailed only Morningside out of Iowa in that poll. Morningside 9-0, the only undefeated team in the top 25 poll in AIA. So Carroll, a lot on the line today. They're looking for their 14th conference championship under head coach Mike Van Deest. He's been here 15 years. And there was one year he did not win the Frontier Conference, but they kept him for the next year. And he did really well. I was kidding. But 14 conference titles for Mike Van Deest, who is the winningest coach at any level right now, who's been in a position in their head coach position for over 10 years, Mike Van Deest, with that honor. So that includes NAIA, all the big schools, et cetera. He has 6 national championships. And as I mentioned, 13 Frontier Conference championships. Looking for number 14 today with a victory. That'll drop if they win and Southern Oregon wins. They'll both have one loss in conference, but Carroll will get that conference championship. And it's all on the strength of the amount of points allowed against conference opponents. And that favors, that tiebreaker favors Carroll College. So the Saints in good shape today, but they're going to have to close out the regular season with a victory here against a tough College of Idaho team, the Coyotes. Lots of underclassmen on this team, but have been playing very well. Lots of experience, and they'll be a force to be reckoned with. Looks like Carroll won the toss, and they have decided to let College of Idaho take that football. They'll defer, and they'll get them turned around here. Carroll will work now, as you can see, from left to right. And then it'll be time for football. As I mentioned, 19 seniors on this squad for Carroll College. All of those seniors were introduced along with their family members to this crowd beforehand. Pretty good crowd on hand, a late filling in crowd. Don't blame them, it's about 13 degrees out there. I'd be late getting to my seat too. A lot of them out still in the tailgate area, but they'll be filling in shortly. Both teams sporting that purple color, Carroll with the home uniforms on, the purple uniforms with the gold trim, and College of Idaho gold pants, those white uniforms and purple numerals. We're just moments away from kickoff. The Fighting Saints and the Coyotes from the College of Idaho. Caldwell, Idaho, they've been averaging, I was reading before the game, 4,500 fans at their home games. So great support down in Caldwell for this team. In fact, their attendance has been higher than some of the schools in the Big Sky, some of the neighboring schools. So it has been a successful year, first year of football for the Coyotes. Ball will be teed up at the 35-yard line and will be set to go. Carroll's kickoff coverage team out on the field. And for Carroll, special teams have played a big role for them this year. They've been very solid on special teams. That's something that Mike Van Deest handles for them. Coulter Hamill is their kicker. And he'll be kicking the ball to number 25, Grant Barrington, along with number 2, that's Corey Brady. He's one of their secondary guys. Looks like Brady's going to take it on the 6. He leads a couple of tacklers, still on his feet. Carroll finally wraps him up, but a good return. He's dropped by number 30 for Carroll. Out at about the 30-yard line for Carroll in on that tackle was Ty Irving. But good field position for the Yotes to start 1st and 10. Carroll defensively solid all year long, giving up just 307 yards per game, averaging 453 yards offensively per game. So here come the Yotes and their quarterback, T.J. Gordon, who leads them not only in passing, obviously, but also in rushing. He is their leading rusher. And he'll start with a single man in the backfield next to him. That's number 46, Clark. And Gordon's going to throw it on first down right over the middle. Intended for number 7. Good coverage that time. Coming up to help to break up that play was number 41, Adam DeBrucker. But the ball intended for Levi Ellsbury, a wide receiver, a junior out of Homedale, Idaho. When you look at the 2-deep lineups for both teams, it is quite obvious that you're looking at a team, College of Idaho, just starting out. They have, on their offensive side, just 3 upperclassmen, in their starting lineup. And by that I mean the juniors or seniors. Just one senior and three juniors. Gordon on the 2nd and 10 this time will hand the ball off. And this is what College of Idaho likes to do, is run the football. More yards running than throwing this year, although they're pretty balanced. And the handoff that time to number 46. That's Ryan Teixeira, the junior. He'll pick up about 5, it looks like, 3rd and 5. So big third down here for the Coyotes as they try to establish something offensively here on their opening possession in the NAIA college football game here at Nelson Stadium, Carroll College. Sheriff's going to run it again. This time he's not going to get that first down. Run really well. And a stop made for Carroll College. Coming across number 42, and he was all over it, as you saw him on the screen. That's Shane Urban, one of the junior linebackers. Conversely for Carroll, I mentioned the upperclassman for College of Idaho on offense. Defensively for Carroll, they start 5 seniors, and that's including, well, 5 seniors plus the punter, Reese Felton. 4 seniors plus the punter, Reese Felton. So, a defensive front heavily senior orientated for Carroll with Condon, Amy, and Groutman. So the Coyotes are going to punt the ball away. And back deep to receive is Anthony Clark. Check that, it's number 1 for Carroll, and he'll field that, and that's, yeah, it is Clark, excuse me. And he'll cut across the 35, still on his feet, there he goes. And really just a touchdown saving tackle made by number 14, Charlie Shepard, otherwise Clark. Would still be running here on senior day. He gets it into Coyote territory, and they're going to spot this football on the Coyote 49-yard line. So Carroll starts their first possession with a short field. They'll break the huddle. Mac Roach, in his first year under the helm, operating this offense for Carroll, has had a fabulous season, taking over for Dakota Stonehouse, who 2-year starter. And they'll go to Rinker, who needs just 5 yards, and he just got about 3 or 4 of them to be one of to move into the top 10 NAIA all-time rushers. He has almost 4,900 yards in his career. An amazing, amazing total for this young man. He's been a solid performer all year long. Spent some time playing behind Chance Demery. He was the previous rushing record holder for Carroll. Rinker has broken that. Roach on a 2nd and 7. Fires the football wide open as Kyle Griffith. They'll finally corral him inside the 30. Tackle made by number 42, but a big pickup that time. On the stop was number 42, Jordan Vialma. He is their leading tackler. But Carroll moving right down the field. Big test here for the Coyotes. Your first year in football in over 30-some years, and you have to travel on the road to take on the number 2 team in the NAIA. This time Roach will keep it himself. Oh, excuse me, it's Clark. Direct snap to Anthony Clark. He's going to move down inside the 5 and then get him out of bounds, but a great run that time. They took Roach out of the game. Missed that. And they put Clark in the backfield, snapped it to him directly, and Anthony Clark can do a lot of things with the football. And that time he shows you what he can do when he gets the ball in his hands and just run with it. He's down inside the 5, down to the 4-yard line, 3-yard line. So Carroll, 1st and goal from the 3. Sunny day here in Helena, Montana. Cold temperatures last night, but it's going to warm up to a brisk 13, maybe 14 degrees today. It might be shirt sleeve weather before we're dead. Mac Roach under center. They'll turn, give the ball to Rinker. Straight ahead, touchdown, Carroll College. That offensive front opened up the hole I could have run through, and Rinker into the end zone. So kudos to the Carroll College Fighting Saint offensive front. They opened a huge hole. Rinker hardly untouched. He's in the end zone at the 11:59 mark here in the first quarter. So on to attempt the extra point for Carroll out of the hold of Reese Felton. And the extra point is up and good. That's Matt Wiest with the extra point. Timeout on the field. Our score, Carroll 7, College of Idaho nothing. Break away. We'll be back.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Before you start your search
for the largest investment in your life,
First Community Bank is here.
Pre-qualification is easy. In most cases, it's the same day.
For first-time home buyers and new construction.
Or your home away from home.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Back at Nelson Stadium, Dustin Rinker on a 3-yard run. And with that run, he joins the top 10 NAIA all-time rushers. Breaks into that elite group with at least this game to go and hopefully more playoff games for Carroll. I mentioned in the pregame, Carroll College in pretty good position. They are ranked number 2 in the NAIA, and should they win today and hold that ranking, they have an opportunity to host playoff games all the way through the semifinal if they can continue to win. They draw very well here at Carroll for their playoff games, so chances are good. They pull this victory out and continue to win on through, that they could work their way all the way to the semifinal, which is what they did last year before they lost to Cumberland in overtime. All right. Kickoff coverage by Carroll and stacked up at the 25-yard line. The return man for the Yotes. And that, again, is number 2 on the return, Corey Brady. So back come the Coyotes. On their first opening possession, Teixeira ran for 7 total yards, and T.J. Gordon, 0 for 1. On the drive, this time, T.J. Gordon will start out of the gun position. He'll send a single receiver wide to the left. That is number 14, Carr. His favorite receiver is his tight end, and this time Gordon will keep it himself, try to get to the edge. And he's tackled from behind by a kid who's done that a lot. That's Sean Bloomquist, running him down from the backside. And holding him to gain a 4, what it looked like. There were more yards available. For Carroll fans, unfortunately, Sean is one of their seniors, but he definitely one of the greatest linebackers in Carroll College history. He set a single season record for tackles for loss and a career record for tackles for loss this year. Last year, 124 tackles and 19 tackles for loss for this kid. It's Teixeira. He'll keep his bricks through. He's still on his feet, trying to drag him down across midfield. Shane Durbin finally gets him. The ball comes out on the tackle, but they're going to say he was down. But a great run by Teixeira. He's down. Super run down to the 40-yard line, but he's still down. He was brought down by 3 Carroll College defenders, and Teixeira, unfortunately, still on the ground. You can see that down in front of us. Ryan Teixeira, the fullback, a junior from Livermore, California, one of the only upperclassmen on the roster, one of few upperclassmen on the roster. Again, unofficially, I counted 79 freshmen on this roster. Teixeira is their second leading rusher, if I remember right. Took a peek at that. T.J. Gordon leads them in rushing this year, their quarterback. We won't speculate what might be going on here. Looks like I think he just got the wind knocked out on the ball underneath him when he landed. Now he's the 30 leading rusher, 284 yards on the season, but he's running it hard right now. Actually, Zach Garzoli, who we have not seen. Maybe we'll see him here in a moment. Zach Garzoli is their second leading rusher behind T.J. Gordon, who has almost 1,000 yards himself on the ground. He's holding that right arm. Hopefully it's not a shoulder problem. We'll see him back later. He's getting up, and he's off under his own power. But a nice run that time for Gordon. And he gets the Yotes down inside the Carroll, down into Carroll territory, down on the 40-yard line. So they'll spot it just inside the 40, first and 10. Carroll leads it 7-0. 11:09 to play here in the first quarter. Gordon will keep it. try to get to the outside, and he hesitates, and four Saint defenders are right there waiting for him. Play action that time. Gordon decided to keep the ball. He read the defense and decided to keep the football rather than handing it to Zach Rosali. And when he did, he started to the outside. Carroll was there, and they'll drop him. For a loss of about two, it'll be second down and 12. Joe McMahon with you. Glad you could join us this afternoon. On a brisk day here in the capital city. Hope it's warm wherever you are. As I mentioned, Carroll defensively pretty stingy, not giving up a lot of yards, just 307 yards on average on the season. This time they'll fire it out complete to number six, and he'll stumble ahead, pick up about close to 7-8 yards. That's Austin Dickey with the reception, first completion for TJ Gordon. Gordon, a junior from Manteca, California. So it's third down for the Coyotes. Carroll, on their first possession, went right down the field and scored. And so for the Yotes, they want to keep their offense on the field. Zach Cooper splits wide to the right. To the left side is number six, Austin Diffie. And Gordon, single man beside him, will hand the ball off to Garzali. And he's not going anywhere. He's stacked up at the line of scrimmage. Sean Conlon there to turn him around. So is number 94, Kyle Smith. He may have gained a yard, but it's going to be fourth and five. Maybe six. Fourth and six for the Coyotes.
Short gain. It will be fourth down.
And it looks like the Coyotes will leave their offense on the field. You're kind of in that position where it's a little too far for a field goal, a little too close to punt the football. If you got any confidence at all in your offense, early in the game, good time to go for it. So they do. They break the huddle. They'll send Zach Cooper wide to the right this time. To the left comes Diffie, Austin Diffie. Gordon's going to roll that way, keep the ball, pitch the ball to Garzali. He'll turn it upfield, get the first down and more. Nice job. Good read that time by Gordon. Coming up to make the tackle for Carroll was number 10, Wymore, along with number 19 for Carroll. And that's Greg Tucker. But a great call that time as they got TJ Gordon to the edge with Garzoli on his hip. He read the defense, and as soon as they committed to come get the quarterback, he pitched the ball. So it is first and 10 for the Coyotes, moving the football inside the Carroll 30-yard line. They trail 7-0. This time, it's Garzoli, and he's going to turn it down the right sideline. Finally pushed out of bounds, but a great run that time. They're moving the ball, gain of about 15. Zach Garzoli, freshman running back from Orland, California. Orland High School. Probably didn't play in many snow days down in Orland, California in high school last year, I would imagine. First and 10 from just outside the 10-yard line for the Coyotes, trying to tie this game up. They're going to give it to Garzoli again, straight ahead on the dive. Not much there.
Ball carried again by Zach Garzoli.
So Garzoli tackled as he gets to the line of scrimmage. Dakota Amy right there along with Sean Bloomquist to bring him down. No gain, it'll be second down and 10. Last weekend, Carroll College defeated Rocky Mountain College. Mm-hmm. 27-10, and Rocky scored on their very first drive, but it was tough going after that. Gordon's going to keep it himself, cut to the outside, blocker out in front of him, puts his head down, tries to bull his way into the end zone, and they'll put him down, but he's close to that first down marker. Nice job that time. Good read for Carroll. The tackle made by James Dalgan, but a gain of 9 for T.J. Gordon. Big third down here. It's third and short. Third and 1 for a first down. Third and about 2.5 for a touchdown. Again, a team that hasn't had football going on in their school for 30-some years. Gordon's going to keep it, get to the outside, and he may win the race to the corner and get to the end zone. He does. T.J. Gordon on a 3-yard run sticks the ball in the end zone, and the Yotes answer Carroll's opening drive. So touchdown, College of Idaho. Comes at the 6:40 mark here at quarter number one. an extra point away from tying it up. On to attempt the extra point is number 95, Luke Taylor. Placement's good. Kicks on its way, and he missed it. Shanked it to the left. So timeout on the field. Our score, it's the Saints 7, the Coyotes 6.
Carroll College 7, College of Idaho 6.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
I maintain my focus just by working my hardest in absolutely everything I do.
In the classroom, on the court, at practice, wherever you're at.
My classes are very rigorous.
At the same time, you need to be able to stay focused and make the right choices and stay on top of things.
Tobacco use would definitely be a negative effect on a student-athlete.
Using tobacco really decreases the performance of any athlete.
I wouldn't be able to dance. I wouldn't be able to hang out with my friends. I wouldn't be able to hike the M. I think that it would make me less of a focused student.
Distract me from my sport and distract me from my academics.
I'm focused on a tobacco.
Welcome, everybody, back to Nelson Stadium. Joe McMahon with you. It is NAI football, the Carroll College Fighting Saints, hosting College of Idaho Coyotes. And the first quarter statistics thus far, 75 yards on the ground for the College of Idaho. Teixeira with the bulk of that, 38 yards, but he has not returned since he was injured on that run of 31 yards that he had just moments ago. Brought the ball inside the 40-yard line, landed on his stomach with two to three Carroll defenders on his back. Got up after a delay, worked his way off the field, but we have not seen him back. So 75 yards on the ground thus far for the Coyotes. And through the air, not many. T.J. Gordon is 1 of 2 for 7 yards. For Carroll, 30 yards on the ground thus far, and 19 through the air. And the Saints lead at 7-6. Clark back to the receive this kickoff, and it'll be taken by Simak, I believe one of the up men. He'll take it, get it across the 30, still going. They'll push him out of bounds at the 37-yard line. There to assist with that tackle, number 2, Corey Brady. Brady had a big week last week. He's a freshman from Boise, Idaho. He had 8 tackles and returned a pair of kickoffs. Had a 6th interception, which leads the league. So he was busy last week in that loss. Coach this time turns, gives to Rinker. He'll work his way back inside. And he is, that offensive line is just getting some good push right now. He'll pick up about 8 yards. It's finally brought down, but not before he does a little bit of damage. Good run that time. Tackle made by number 13, Jordan Jacobs. To check that. No, that's right, it was Jordan Jacobs. A little smoke moving across the stadium. Somebody's barbecue a little bit out of control, perhaps. I'm not sure. Yeah. My wife would automatically blame me, but I am innocent this time. All right. So it is second down for the Carroll College Fighting Saints. Second and short. With Rinker behind him, Roach approaches the line of scrimmage. That veteran offensive front leading the way as they have all year long. Left tackle Josh James, left guard Tyson Cooper, the center Alex Castens, a 3-year starter. Right guard is Ryan Armstrong, and the right tackle is Dominic Sally, a senior. So Sally, Castens, and Cooper, all seniors along that front. Other seniors in the starting lineup, Dustin Rinker, who we mentioned, who just joined a very elite group of rushers in NAIA history, all time. He's in the top 10 now. Jared Marinick and also Anthony Clark. In motion, that's Simak coming back into the formation, lines up on a wing. And they're going to give the ball to Rinker one more time, get that first down and more, and he does. He needed to. He picked up 4. He stopped by number 59 that time, Josh Price. But he'll steadily move the ball down the field. Dustin, as I said, needed 9 yards coming into today's game, or 5 yards coming into today's game to join that elite group of top 10 rushers in NAIA history. And he is there and then some. unofficially, he has three attempts for 15 yards. This time Roach will operate out of the gun, two receivers to either side. He's going to step back, survey the defense, and throw it to a wide-open Kyle Griffith, who simply dropped the football. Went to tuck it away on his hip, and it wasn't there anymore. Number two coming up to make the stop, Corey Brady. But for Griffith, probably one he'd like to try again. He's probably made that catch 300 times this year, between spring drill, practice, all of it. Second and 10, wide to the right goes Clark, single coverage out here. Clark having an incredible year. Saints top receiver. Roach is gonna look his way. Looking down the center of the field now, he's gonna fire that football wide open as Griffith. He'll get it right back to him. And kudos to Nick Hallett, the offensive coordinator, for going right back to Kyle Griffith. And this time he made the catch. Maybe that's why he dropped the first one. He knew there was a better one coming on second down. He's down to inside the 25, down to the 21-yard line. Wide open. Griffith, with Marinick and Clark being seniors, he and Simak, the heir apparent to those two receivers that have been steady all year. But Kyle Griffith came in last year as a true freshman from Glacier High School. And an outstanding job, and it continues this year. Trips to the right this time. Marinick, single coverage to the left. Empty backfield. No tight ends. So either Roach is going to run it, or this ball's going in the air. And he's going to get sacked. Neither one. Great job that time, coming flying through that time and putting him on the ground before he had chances really to set his feet, was number 59, but Josh Price. Very impressive play. Big loss that time, a loss of 10 yards. So it's going to be second and 20 for Carroll at the 32-yard line. This time, Roach will keep Rinker in the backfield to help the offensive line in case number 59 has the same plans as he had on the last play, Josh Price. In fact, they'll give it to Rinker, and he'll bust it through on the right side. It's back a little bit of the yard as they lost on the sack, but it's going to leave Carroll for third and long. Good job this time by number 21 to come in and make that tackle defensively. That is Nate Moore, the sophomore out of Boise, Idaho, the sophomore corner. So for Carroll, they face a 3rd and 13, 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. They lead 7-6. Wide to the left is Marinick. Two receivers to the right, and in motion this time is Clark. Roach is looking straight down the field. He's going to throw that football wide open was Kyle Griffith, but Roach missed it. So that brings up an interesting situation. It's 4th and 13, so they're going to bring out their field goal team, attempt a lengthy field goal of almost 43 yards. Reese Felton will put it down on the 33-yard line, so Matt Wiest will attempt a 43-yard field goal. The freshman out of Albany, Oregon lines it up, literally no wind. Off the right hash, Felton sets it up and places the football, kicks on its way, and it's not going anywhere. Ball's going to roll into the end zone, in out of the end zone. It looked like we slipped. His plant foot went out from underneath him. And the Coyotes will get the ball back. 7-6 our score. Good football game taking place right here. Again, Carroll, a lot on the line. A win here, and they secure their 14th conference victory. And Mike Van Dee's tenure. He's been here 15 years and they've won the conference 14 times. That is amazing. Frontier Conference, not an easy thing to win. Year in and year out, they are at or near the top. Many, many Frontier Conference teams still waiting for Carroll to have that year, that off year, and it just hasn't happened. I mean, even when they didn't win it, they were second. So first and 10 for the Coyotes. TJ Gordon brings them back out. In their last possession, they moved the ball right down the field and scored, but I don't see Teixeira back out there. He got injured. They're going to throw a quick screen out, a bubble screen out to number 6. Nice block thrown that time by their big tight end to free up the receiver, Austin Giffey. So it's a gain of about 6 that time. Coyotes doing a good job of mixing it up offensively. First down, you don't see run, run, run. It's a mixture. So TJ Gordon comes to the line of scrimmage. Zach Garzoli on his left hip. And he'll give it to Garzoli straight ahead on the dive play, and there's not much running room. Garzoli, not a very big guy. And when he got to the line of scrimmage, he was met by some very big guys. So he didn't go very far. Leading the way was Dakota Amy. Sean Blomquist there to help him out. Blomquist is, I guess, tired of wearing that arm pad. He just fired that thing off the field. He's got a pretty good arm himself. If you can make an arm pad fly 20 yards, what can you do with a football? I mean, my gosh, you should have never let the kid throw a ball. All right, so it's a big third down, third and three for the Coyotes. Four-man front for Carroll. Gordon's going to get to the edge and turn it. Good job blocking. He's got the first down and then some. He'll be pushed out of bounds, but not till he gets to the 49-yard line. Forced out of bounds by James Dowgan, but TJ Gordon is quick. 5'11", 185-pound junior out of Modesto Community College. So AJC transfer brought in, and he is performing quite well. Leads the team in rushing and in passing. First and 10. This time Gordon will try to get to the outside. He'll turn it inside. Gordon's there, or Condon, excuse me, is there to meet TJ Gordon and bring him to the turf. Blomquist helps him out. So it's Condon and Blomquist again. A little bit of assistance from number 41 on that tackle. That's Adam DeBrucker out of Shoto, Montana. Second and 9 this time as Mike Van Deest makes some adjustments defensively. This game is a chess match for the coaches. Oftentimes, what you plan and prep for doesn't happen in the first quarter as the other team puts in some new wrinkles they haven't used. Or the tendencies that they've shown throughout the year up to that point suddenly change and your defense is not ready for it. So it takes some quick adjustments. Gordon's going to fire the ball out and has it tipped by Sean Condon. And it's an incomplete pass, but good job by Condon to get his hands up. They were trying to set up a bubble screen on the right flat. It looked like it would have been pretty well set up. Austin Diffie out there with two blockers in front of him, but Condon saw it, put his pot, knocked the ball down, and it's third and long. So Carroll will bring on an extra defensive back. They'll get number 95 off the field. That's Jeff Geck. And they bring in number 19, Greg Tucker. They'll rush three, and they'll drop five. Gordon's going to look to throw. Condon's all over him. He lets go of that ball early. He got tattooed. Had to let it go a lot earlier than he wanted, and it's because Sean Condon was in his grill. Condon just drilled him back on the inside the 45-yard line. So the ball falls incomplete. So the Saint defense turns the Coyotes away. They'll punt the football. That'll be number 36 standing back to punt the ball. Kevin McLemore. And he will line up on about his 37-yard line. Anthony Clark for Carroll back on the 10-yard line. Clark, an Idaho product. He is out of Blackfoot, Idaho. So 1:13 to go. It's 7-6, Carroll. We're in the first quarter. Joe McMahon with you from Nelson Stadium. McLemore. Snap is good. Rugby punt. He'll kick it down the right side, try to keep it away from Clark. Carroll will let it roll, and it'll take a Coyote bounce inside the 10-yard line. They'll down it at about the 7. That's where the Saints will take over first through 10. 7-6 our score, 1:02 to go. The Fighting Saints looking for win number 9. Great football game going on. And if you're tired of that, would like something different, we could pan the cameras over to the sledding hill across the way because there's some action going on over there, too. There's some kids flying down that hill. Maybe a little bit of that later. If it's out of hand? Okay. Right. I can do the play-by-play for that, maybe. They'll hand it off. It's Rinker, and look out. He's loose. Dustin Rinker just picked his way through the line of scrimmage, and the next thing you know, he's 12 yards upfield. This is the first time the College of Idaho has faced Dustin Rinker because he wasn't here 37 years ago, but he certainly is a force to be reckoned with, and they're finding that out quickly. Dustin off to a phenomenal day here on Senior Day. He had 26 yards prior to that carry, so he's near 40. We are 40 seconds away from the end of the first quarter. He's going to get it again. He'll duck it back inside, hesitate, put his head down, get underneath the defenders. Number 17 there to stop him, but he gets good positive yardage again. Tyler Andreessen, linebacker, a freshman from Howe, Idaho, made this tackle, but not before Rinker picked up another five. And they're going to let the clock run down, I believe, and that'll be the final play of quarter number one.
So a quarter in the books, the Saints on top, 7-6. Final game of the year for College of Idaho. Carroll looking for more playoff action next week, but they lead it at this point, 7-6. We'll be back.
At MT Glass Liquor, we have an enormous selection of liquors to choose from at affordable prices. From specialty liquors to wines and mixers, our variety is second to none. If you're looking for a unique item, we have it in stock. As a Montana State liquor store, we offer wholesale prices and offer monthly sales. Our friendly, knowledgeable staff will help you pick out the perfect item for the right occasion. So stop in to MT Glass Liquor, your cocktail headquarters.
An accident can ruin your day, and you're going to need all the help you can get. Help, I Crashed My Car is an app for your phone that'll give you that help. Based on GPS technology, Help, I Crashed My Car makes contacting the police, emergency services, tow truck, and your family members quick and easy. To add Help, I Crashed My Car to your phone, visit collisionpro.com and click on the command to download the app, and you'll be set. Collision Pro is here to help you get your car back on the road.
Set to start quarter number two at Nelson Stadium. Joe McMahon with you. Welcome back, everybody. First quarter statistics. Take a peek at them. First downs, 5 for College of Idaho. Same for Carroll. 13 passing yards for the Yotes. Carroll with 48 through the air. 108 total yards for the Coyotes. For Carroll, 104. So pretty even, and the score's that way, too. Time of possession, however, not even. Carroll had the ball for just a little over 5 minutes, and College of Idaho almost 11. So 2-1 time advantage on possession. And that's one way to slow down this Carroll offense, is keep them off the field. Keep your offense out there, run the football. And the College of Idaho able to do that. First quarter, they've been doing that all year long. It's the second quarter that they have not had a lot of success. They have been outscored significantly in the second quarter. I'll get that for you here. They've been outscored 124-41 in the second quarter. So they start out like a ball of fire, but they seem to struggle later on. A lot of that might be depth. As you start a new program, you don't have a lot of depth. Roach will drop back, look to throw the football. He's got all day, wide open is Clark, and he's running away from the defender. Finally gets him out of bounds, but just too much speed that time for number 42 to handle. Velma. Clark, the senior out of Blackfoot, Idaho, was moving, scooting across the field. Roach hit him in stride, and it's a Carroll first down. Across the 35 to 37-yard line. The Saints are on the move again. Nick Hallett, the offensive coordinator, has been for the entire tenure of Coach Mike Van Diest. Van Diest runs the defense, Hallett the offense. Roach this time, give the ball to Rinker, and he's going to follow his quarterback, who'll throw a block for him, and he's getting across midfield. He's still on his pins. Rinker running hard today. Check that. It wasn't Rinker. That's Jordan Pine. I stand corrected. Jordan Pine, the senior with that carry, number 22. Regardless, running very hard down inside the 50, down to the 43-yard line. Pine, one of the seniors. Not a lot of rushing yards for Jordan coming into today's game, but he has scored, I believe, 3 touchdowns on the season. 2-1 game against Southern Oregon here in that thriller that Carroll won 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. Rinker in the backfield, and this time he'll get it. As Pine steps out, more running room for Dustin. Picks up another 5 yards before number 17, or number 13, excuse me, in there on the tackle for the Coyotes. That's Jordan Jacobs. So Carroll seemingly moving the ball at will down the field. Scored on their first opening possession. They'll send 3 receivers to the left side. Their second drive stalled deep in Yote territory. Roach is looking to go down the field to Clark. It's going to, or to Simak, and he overshoots him. He had two receivers in the same area, Simak and Clark, both running go routes up the left sideline. Good coverage that time by the Coyotes. So it'll be third and five for Carroll. Not something you see frequently, two receivers running go routes and they're within 5 yards of each other. Jordan Pine will check back in, so will Kyle Griffith as Rinker sits down. Pine, a very good receiver, as well as a tough running back, who just hasn't had a lot of opportunities playing behind Rinker. Roach is going to throw the football wide open, and making the catch is Anthony Clark. Great catch. It made it look easy, but he had to reach out across his body, both hands, snag that ball, and Roach put some mustard on it. He caught it down at the 31-yard line. Stepped right out of bounds, and Carroll, first and 10. That's a play they run all the time in summer drill. They practice that little down and out route, and that's why they make it look easy. Not nearly as easy as it appeared on that play. First and 10 for the Saints. 13:09 to play here in the second quarter. It is a one-point difference. Carroll 7, College of Idaho 6. And Rinker's trying to get to the outside. And it's Pine to the outside, down to the 20. And he is finally running people over inside the 10-yard line. Jordan Pine down to the 5-yard line. Running like a diesel truck that time. One of the poor corners just got run over inside the 10. I'm not sure if he knows what happened. But Jordan Pine showing some power. Great run by Pine. Gain of about 25 yards. And that'll set up Carroll first and goal at the 5-yard line. With Rinker back in there, Bloomquist in there at the blocking back position, although they've been known to give it to him a time or two. And they're going to give it to him. Bloomquist trying to get into the end zone on a rare carry for their all-star middle linebacker. Bloomquist tackled inside the 5-yard line. Number 13 again in on that stop. That's Troy Carr. He's been busy. Gain of a yard and a half. And for Bloomquist, he's coming out of the game. Not because he's a bad player. It's just they need him on defense too. So it's going to be second down and 3. They'll go with a single running back. It's Rinker alone in the backfield. With a wing on the left side. Extra blocker. And Rinker's going to cut it back inside, stick his head down, and didn't get into the end zone, but he's down about the 1-yard line, so it's going to be third down and about a yard and a half. So a big play here for both the Coyote defense and the Saint offense. The Saints leading at 7-6, 11:32 to go in the second quarter. Joe McMahon with you from Nelson Stadium. It's Rinker. Touchdown. They stood him up, but he still had enough power to sneak it into the end zone. And Dustin Rinker with his second touchdown run of the first half. And it comes at the 11:20 mark, quarter two. Rinker off to another phenomenal start here today. He now has close to 50 yards. And Matt Wiest was on to attempt the extra point. Reese Felton, the senior, is the holder. Reese averaging about 46 yards a punt. There's talk of him getting a shot at playing on Sundays next year. There's the snap and the placement. The kick's on its way. And it's good. Timeout on the field. Carroll College jumps back out on top, 14-6, 11:20 to play. Carroll 14, College of Idaho 6.
Check it out, the 2014 Ford F-150. Looks great, but let's build one for me. I need a 4x4 with plenty of power, because back here I'll be pulling my boat. Add some chrome, 18s, ooh, some fog lamps, nice. The XLT 4x4. What's this? Just announced, get over $10,000 in total value on F-150, or lease one for $259 a month? Now just gotta choose a color. Ooh, black. The XLT F-150. Better hurry, it all ends soon.
Before you start your search
for the largest investment in your life,
First Community Bank is here.
Pre-qualification is easy. In most cases, it's the same day.
For first-time home buyers and new construction.
Or
your home away from home.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Welcome back, everybody. Joe McMahon with you. Missing my partner, Peter Young, who's on another assignment, as they say in the business. Hopefully back with us next week for playoff football. Carroll, ranked number 2 in the NAIA, looking for their 14th conference title here this afternoon with a victory. They would finish, should both Carroll and Southern Oregon win today, they would finish at 9-1, identical record to Southern Oregon. They split their two games this year. It goes all the way to the third tiebreaker, which is number of points scored against your defense in conference games. And Carroll with the advantage there, so that's it. Ball is going to bounce out of bounds at the 10-yard line, so they'll spot the ball, I believe, at the, if I remember right, the 25. And it'll be Carroll or Coyote football, first and 10 from the 30-yard line, excuse me, 30. So Carroll and College of Idaho, two teams with similar colors, but a whole different way of getting here and a whole different history for the Fighting Saints. Another solid year, another year that appears to be headed right for the playoffs again. They got all the way into the semifinal game last year here at home, losing to Cumberland in overtime. They'd like to make a similar trip, except they'd like two more victories. Gordon will fire the football out complete. Nice throw that time. And the reception, Wymore throws the receiver out of bounds, but the ball completed to number 80. And that was Zach Cooper, sophomore wide receiver from Meridian, Idaho. He'll pick up 7 on the play. Gordon gets rid of the ball quickly. Carroll unable to get to him consistently. He's also a very, very dangerous runner. Likes to get to the corner. They like to run that zone read. Where they get to the edge, and he makes a decision. Play action, he'll fire it over the middle. Wide open is this tight end, and I mean wide open. Inside the 30, he may go. He's being chased inside the 10. Touchdown, nice pass that time. And a huge strike of 65 yards. The pass completed, 60 yards. The pass completed to number 85, Marcus Linhart. That is their leading receiver. So touchdown College of Idaho, and with that they answer immediately. Carroll scores. Their first extra point was shanked wide to the left. So we go for 2. They're going to line it up and try and get the extra point here. Elsberry is the holder. There's a snap in place. He kicks off his way, and this one is no good. He missed him again. So not a good day thus far for Luke Taylor. He just missed his second one, but a touchdown puts the lead back to 14-12. 10:43 to go. 14-12 is our score. Back once again at Nelson Stadium. An unexpected visitor to the booth just moments ago, Santa Claus made his appearance. Looked in, looked down, saw me, and left. Huh, it's not a good sign. Oh well, another year. Give it my best shot next year, same as this year. Big strike, however, for College of Idaho. Beautiful play. Marcus Lenhart wide open. A blown coverage definitely for Carroll College because Lenhart, the tight end, is their leading receiver. And he was cruising down the middle of the field as if he was running in pregame drills. T.J. Gordon delivered the ball in stride, and Lenhart did the rest of the damage on the ground. He has 41 receptions. So here comes Carroll College's Marinick on the return. And pretty good special teams coverage as he started to turn the corner. The 25 brings him down. That's Grant Barrington. Barrington drops him, and it'll be Carroll football. 27-yard line. So it's a relatively close game, 14-12. We're at 10:38 to go here in quarter number two. On 50, Yotes blow out in the making. College of Idaho, a very dominant, a very talented football team. A bunch of underclassmen, mainly freshmen and sophomores. They have a bright future. Coach is going to roll to his right, gets a block from that right tackle, steps up, throw the football wide open to Simak. He's got it. At midfield, he'll get a few more yards. They'll bring him down. He'll stay in bounds. Simak did a nice job of catching the football and then turning it upfield. But a huge gain from the 27-yard line. They push it up ahead about 27, 28, 27 yards. So one play and they're right back in Yoke territory. Fighting Saints 8-1 in the season, number two ranking in the NAIA poll. College of Idaho was receiving some votes in that poll early in the season when they won four of their first five. It's Rinker, and he is across the 45 into Yoke territory, down about the 43-yard line. Prior to that carry, Dustin Rinker with 50 yards on the ground. Give him four, so 54 thus far. He has had, as we mentioned, a phenomenal career. He came into today's game with 4,897 yards. Roach under center this time. It's dropped straight back. Play action. Look to throw the football. He's got Clark coming, trying to get back to the football. Can't get there, and there's a penalty flag. Mac Judge threw the flag as Clark tried to come back to the ball. He got tangled up with number 21. That's Nate Moore. Moore drew the coverage that time on Anthony Clark. The official's talking it over. And the official. We'll talk it over, see what the call is. The referee comes down to get the call. Here it comes. Yeah, it's pass interference on the defense. For a moment there, I was wondering if he was going to pick up that flag. He was having a conversation with the side judge. But the back judge went with what he called, and it is a Saint first down. It's not a spot foul, but they'll move the ball ahead and spotted inside the 30-yard line down at the 28. Trips to the left this time for the Fighting Saints. Roach sends Clark by himself to the right. Here comes some pressure, sending a couple linebackers. Roach will step up, throw the football, wide open is Griffith. Down on the goal line, he's close to the goal line, down slides, sliding catch down to the 2-yard line. Roach is making it look pretty easy. He's just picking these guys apart. It'll be Carroll College ball, first and 10 from the Coyote 3-yard line, first and goal from the Coyote 3-yard line. Roach off to a pretty good day himself. He is, prior to that pass, 5 of 8 for 96 yards. So he's over 100 yards passing right now. Rinker, lone setback. Will he get his third touchdown? Yep, just did. Touchdown, Carroll. Untouched into the end zone again goes Dustin Rinker. And this one comes at the 9:08 mark of quarter number two. So Matt Weist, one of the busiest men on the Carroll football team, he's on to attempt another extra point. The The College of Idaho Coyotes have missed their two extra point attempts. Both of them shanked to the left side. We're showing them how to do it here. This one's right down the center. So timeout on the field, 9:08 to play here in the first half of action. It's the Saints 21, the Coyotes 12.
Beautifiers is now a Hunter Douglas Gallery dealer. Visit our new showroom that showcases the newest in Hunter Douglas window coverings in full size that you can touch and feel. At Home Beautifiers, we promise an enjoyable and easy shopping experience, from initial design consultation to professional measuring and installation, all backed by the Hunter Douglas Lifetime Guarantee. We will make your home more inviting and beautiful.
Home Beautifiers, we make your house a home.
360 Office Solutions, for everything from office supplies, to office machines, to space design, to school supplies, even coffee, and dogs. We are part of the largest wholesale buying group of office supplies in the country, which means you get the best of both worlds. National level pricing tied with local level service. Whether you walk in the store, order online, or work with our sales consultants, 360 Office Solutions is your answer. And we deliver smart answers everywhere you turn. 360 Office Solutions.
He averages 272 yards a game in the air, so he's rolling right along. Back again at Nelson Stadium. Carroll College right back on the scoreboard this time. It's another run by Dustin Rinker, his third touchdown run of the game. So he's been productive on the ground, getting into the end zone, but getting in there was Mac Roach on his arm, as he found Kyle Griffith running a crossing route. Inside the 5-yard line. Kyle Griffith slid to the ground, made the catch, and Rinker took it in the rest of the way. This ball will be fielded at the 12-yard line. Trying to get to the left side and up the middle is number 25, and picks up a little yardage. That's Grant Darrington. Tackle made by number 31, Eric Dawson, for Carroll. And that's where the Coyotes will start off, first and 10. Their offense has been moving the football. 95 yards on the ground thus far, 78 through the air. Gordon is 4 of 7, TJ is, for 78 yards. Teixeira, their leading rusher, 38 yards, but we have not seen him since the first quarter when he was injured on a tackle. I don't know if he'll be back. When he walked off, his back was to us, but it looked like he was favoring that right arm. So Gordon out of the gun this time. Keeps it, tries to get to the outside as the tailback, and the ball comes out after the tackle, but I think he was down. Yeah, he was down. Bloomquist and company dropped the running back, Rizzoli. A loss of about 3. So Rizzoli could not get to the outside. Carroll making some adjustments defensively. Good news, it looks like number 46 is back out there. That's Ryan Teixeira. Yeah, he is. They'll throw it to him now on the flat left side, but not a lot of place to go. His number 96 right there when he made the catch, Brian Grotman. Defensive tackle. That shows you how quick these defensive linemen are for Carroll. The defensive tackle got out there and made that tackle when they swung the ball out to number 46, Teixeira, the junior fullback from Livermore, California. Good to see him back out there. So, speculation that might be a right arm injury. Not true. Just got the wind knocked out of him. He's back out there and playing well. Two receivers to the right side. One of them is that tight end who just scored moments ago on a 65-yard pass completion. This time it's Teixeira straight. No, it's Gordon going to keep it. On play actions. Missed tackle by number 19, but he had some help as he slowed him down. Coming up initially is Greg Tucker, but he couldn't quite bring him down. So Shane Durbin came over, so did Wymore. And they'll stop him for a gain of about maybe 4. We got a penalty flag near the line of scrimmage. Yeah, it's a penalty against the defense, and they'll decline it. Carroll will. And that'll bring up a 4th down. So Off comes the offense for the Coyotes. Carroll will get set to return this punt. Anthony Clark will drop back at about the 35-yard line of the Coyotes. With 7:51 to play, Carroll up 21-12. As I mentioned, Coyotes all kinds of trouble in the second quarter all year long. Being outscored 124-41. First quarter has been there, 73-56 they outscored their opponents, but since then, not good. With the second quarter being the most glaring, troublesome quarter. Kick hits the ground, hits one of the Coyotes on the back, and I think it's dead. I think the ball's dead right there. Yeah, number 29 running down to make coverage, to cover the punt, excuse me. Had the ball hit him in the backfield, Malik Whitfield. Sprinting down the field, whack, right between the numbers. It's either a low-flying single or the ball is not elevated. So it'll be first and 10 for the Saints, and they're gonna start in Yote territory. Start at the Yote 44-yard line. With Clark and Simak wide to the right side. Griffith to the left. Coyotes are going to send five, and Carroll's going to run the football. Pine gets to the outside, turns it upfield. He's got 10 yards and then some. They still can't get him down. Finally drop him after a gain of about 16, but Jordan Pine, impressive here late in the year. Tyler Andreessen with the tackle, but a huge run for Pine. He does not get many opportunities to carry the football. That's just his third attempt, and he's making the most of it. With that run, he will be 50-plus yards as well, along with Rinker on the ground. So the Saints start first and 10 this time from the 28. Roach under center this time, and it's Rinker on the delay inside. And Carroll offensive front doing some damage. Bowls ahead for two, maybe 3 yards. Better job defensively that time by the Coyotes at number 59, who was in on that stop. That's Josh Price. Gain of two, at least second and eight. Marinick brings the play in from Nick Hallett. On a second down and eight. Roach out of the gun this time. Single running back on his hip. That's Rinker's gonna stand and block. Corner blitz this time. They'll throw it wide open as Griffith, and I mean wide open. Touchdown, Carroll. Yikes. 27-yard touchdown pass to Kyle Griffith, the sophomore wide receiver who was having a picnic in the end zone, and it is 27-12, Carroll. So on to attempt the extra point again is Matt Wiest. Out of the hold of Reese Felton, the punter. Kicks up and it is good. Timeout on the field. Our score, Carroll 28 now, College of Idaho 12. Looks like we are staying here during this. The Red Hats who commonly look for to see if we're taking a break or taking a break themselves. So 28-12, the Pumpkin. Do they change hats too when they do that? I don't know. 28-12 the score. The Fighting Saints answered that 65-yard pass that College of Idaho had from TJ Gordon to Marcus Linhart with two quick touchdowns of their own. Rinker on a 3-yard run at the 908 mark, and Carroll's Kyle Griffith running free in the right down the middle of the field, a crossing route, wide open, and Roach delivered it on target. And it is now 28-12, Carroll. Thus far, on the ground, Carroll, 133 yards with Jordan Pine, the leading rusher. Three attempts, 60 yards. That's pretty good. 20-yard average per carry, that's not bad. Dustin Rinker, 13 carries for 58 yards thus far. And Anthony Clark, one carry for 23 yards. So 133 yards on the ground and through the air. Mac Roach having another great day, 7 of 10 for 148 yards. So the Coyotes will get an opportunity here with 6:11 to go in the half to answer that touchdown. And they'll head right straight up the middle, but number two is going to be met there by a bevy of defenders. On the return was Corey Brady. and he ran it right into the teeth of the coverage team, and they'll drop him at the 25-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 for the Coyotes and T.J. Gordon. Beautiful afternoon for football here. Glad you could join us. Joe McMahon with you. Santa Claus has been in and out a couple times. Maybe he'll be back. I wonder if it would help if I invited him up for Thanksgiving dinner. Nah, it's probably too late. First and 10, the Yotes will start from their 26-yard line. Trying to get to the edge this time, breaking one tackle. His number three can't break the next one. That's Isaac Gonzalez. Slowing him down was Sean Bloomquist, who came firing through there. Sean Bloomquist came from the linebacker position, got a hand on him and spun him. Slowed him down, and everybody else came in and cleaned him up. So the second down, gain of one on the play, second and 9. Gordon out of the gun this time. He's going to zone read, give the ball to first man. And going nowhere. This is running back stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. With the carry again was number 46 back in there. That's Ryan Teixeira. He's going to come off this time on a third and long, so Teixeira checks out. Third and long, and a big down here for the Coyotes. They really do need a first down here. You give this ball back to Carroll, and you may be down more than what you are now heading into the locker room, because Carroll's offense is on a roll at the moment. Big down, and they know it's a big down. They'll take a timeout and talk it over. So the coaching staff said, we got to talk this over. We don't like the formation. So. Timeout on the field, 28-12 is the score.
A message from Montana Department of Transportation Traffic Safety Office. Buckle up every trip, every time, even at slow speeds.
We'll keep it here. You can see Coach Van Dees calling his defense over there, going to discuss a couple possibilities, what they might see here. The Coyotes have only thrown to their tight end once, Marcus Lenhart, but he was wide open on that play. He is, as I mentioned, their leading receiver coming into this game. Big, tall kid. There's number 85, 6'4", freshman from Eagle, Idaho. Great hands. He's had at least 5 receptions and 70 yards in 5 different games this year, so they've used him frequently. He's number 3. He's right now in the number 3 spot on the single season receiving yards list with 636 yards. So as a freshman, he's already got a big, big contribution. Well, here we go. Out of the timeout. Third down. Gordon out of the gun. Backs on either hip. He's going to drop back straight back to throw it. There might be a flag there. Wait a minute. What do we got here? Yeah, we got a timeout. Or we got a penalty flag. Excuse me. The play whistled dead before it really got started. It's a procedure call against College of Idaho. I can see the official indicating that right now, the side judge. Yep, it's a false start call, so they'll back him up 5 yards. And actually, that's good news for College of Idaho, because there was a very obvious holding call. Brian Grotman's jersey was being pulled from behind, right in front of the officials. So the dead play. Back him up 5 yards and start over. So a third down and 13. They're going to roll to the right this time on his own read. Carroll's out there, and they're going to turn the ball upfield. And the ball came out. Bounce came right back up into T.J. Gordon's stomach. Gordon gets to the gains up some of that yardage. Lost on the penalty, but not nearly enough for the first down. So it's a fourth and long. It's fourth and 9, and Carroll is going to get the ball back with lots of time. Plenty of time. It'll be just over 4 minutes by the time this transition takes place. Kevin McLemore drops back to punt the football. He's standing on his own 11-yard line, and Anthony Clark, the always dangerous Anthony Clark, awaits this punt at the 38-yard line. Let's see what Carroll does. They're going to set up a return to try and go after this. They're going to return. Rugby punt. They'll get it away. Pretty good kick from McLemore. Fielded by Clark as he's backpedaling, looking for a seam, trying to get the outside. Bloomquist trying to hold a block. He'll turn it upfield at the 30. Good coverage that time. He's knocked out of bounds at the 34, but great pursuit that time, staying in the lanes and pushing him out of bounds on the College of Idaho sidelines was number 24, Kyle Cawthorn. Cawthorn with the stop. So Carroll takes over, first and 10. Leading right now by 16, looking to stretch that. 3:51 to go here in the first half. Carroll tried to set this up to win their Frontier Conference, win the Frontier Conference for the 14th time in 15 years under the direction of Mike Van Deest. Rinker trying to get to the outside in a hurry. He's got some tacklers that are some blockers out there in front of him, but a good job of pursuit that time from the backside, number 59. He's been in on lots of plays today. I've called his name a lot. Josh Price. He's all over the field. So it's second and five. Rinker picks up five on that carry. And the Saints send two people to the left side, two receivers to the left side. There's Roach up under center. Clock running 3:10. It's Rinker again, trying to bust it to the outside. He ducks under. Didn't quite, he's close. I was going to say he didn't quite get to the first down. He did five. I think he got about four. Third and one for Carroll. So third and one, let's see what Coach Nick Hallett has in mind. Expecting a run on the Coyotes, but Carroll's going to throw it. Roach is going to roll to the right, try to pick it up himself with his feet, and he'll get there. He needed a yard. He got about six. Run out of bounds. They'll spot it. Thought he got inside the 50, but he didn't. They'll spot it at the 49-yard line. So gain of five on the run that time for Roach. Doesn't run very often, but a good call that time. His College of Idaho really stacked up at the line of scrimmage expecting Rinker. And they didn't get him. Roach instead spun out to the right side and picked up 4 yards. On the day, Carroll 148 yards on the ground. 103 for College of Idaho. Two receivers to the left side, tight ends in this time, double tight set. Rinker line stays in the backfield. He's going to block Roach's drop it back. He's going to let that ball go. He's trying to get it down to Clark, and he overshoots his intended receiver, who stumbled a bit, got his feet tangled with number 21, Nate Moore. So they'll stretch the defense on that play, come up empty. Griffith will step off the field, Marinick in, along with Jordan Pine. Rinker's coming off as well. So Coach Hallett able to get a lot of different players out there, skill position players, substituting Rinker and Pine quite a bit in this half. This time, they're going to run Pine to the left side. He's got a head of steam, but great job pursuing that time and bringing him down, number 17, Tyler Andreessen, another tackle for Tyler. Pine turns the corner, picks up a couple yards. It'll be third down, third and about eight. 1:41 to play, 1:40 clock on the move, 28-12 our score. Carroll would love to pick up this first down, keep the drive alive. That's Clark splits wide to the right, Griffith in the slot that side, two receivers to the left side with Marinick being split widest. Roach is looking that way. It's Marinick on the screen pass. It was set up really well, he just didn't catch the football. Threw it a little bit out in front of him. He reached for it, probably one he should have made, and he dropped the football. So Carroll's going to have to punt the football, not something they've done much of today at all. Reese Felton will step onto the field, the senior. And he will set up at about the 36-yard line. Felton, phenomenal punter for Carroll. One of the best in the conference and in the NAIA. There's the snap. He's going to run it. It's a fake punt. He's going to get a block. And he's got the first down. Good block out front by number 42, Shane Irvin. And Reese Felton with College of Idaho planning to return that punt says, I can run the ball. Surprise call by Mike Van Deest. and it surprised everybody. We just felt he's going to come over to the sideline, talk to Coach Van Diesten and say, see, you should have been playing me at tailback all along. Did you see that? But a great block by number 42 out in front of that play, Shane Durbin. He got his hands on that defender, and then when the defender turned, he took his hands off to avoid the holding call. First and 10, Carroll, can they strike now? Roach is going to step up, try to avoid the tackler. Good job defensively that time, coming up from his corner position. I believe that's number 24. It wasn't a timeout for Carroll. But number 24 came up to make that stop, Kyle Cawthorn. So Carroll's going to take a timeout, 28-12 our score. Looks like we're staying here. Good first half of action. It was 14-12 just moments ago, but two quick scores by the Saints. And they are now in Coyote territory with 38 seconds to go. And no doubt Coach Van Diest, Coach Hallett, they're thinking more points. There's Santa Claus, he's right down in front of us. Dressed in red, so it's nice to see Santa showing up in red, although he generally does wear red, but showing no preference to either team. ...28-12, 38 seconds to play here in the first half. College of Idaho football back on their campus for the first time in 37 years. Roach will drop back, throw the football. Wide open is the receiver, Simak, trying to avoid the corner. Gets past him, comes close to that first down. They're going to stop the clock and check this, 31 seconds to go. They're going to move the sticks, and while they do that, the clock stops. Carroll at the line of scrimmage, ready to go. Next play with Rinker in the backfield and Roach up under center. They are set, and Roach is just going to spike the football. Carroll got a first down, so he went up to the line of scrimmage, quickly spiked the ball, ran 4 seconds off the clock. They still have plenty of time, 27 seconds. They could score in a blink. They've shown that throughout the day already. College of Idaho really fighting for their lives here. They realize the score here. And that put them down 35-12 going into the locker room with the extra points. And that's a tough deficit to overcome here in the second half in Nelson Stadium against a very stout defense. Twin receivers to either side. Rinker stays in to block on a 2nd and 10. Roach will drop straight back. Pressure coming. They'll fire the football wide open to Simak. And if he's smart, he'll get out of bounds. And he is. He gets out of bounds at the 10-yard line. So he ran an under route. Clearing the area was Anthony Clark. He ran a go route right up the right sideline. Simak came in behind him. So with the safety paying attention to Clark, which he should be doing, Simak got free. And Roach found him. Ran 7 seconds off the clock, and they moved the football down the field. It's 1st and 10 for Carroll. 1st and 10 for a first down. 1st and 11 for a touchdown. Roach, again, pressure coming. Steps up, throw the football. Just overshoots Clark. Had him. But he threw the ball a bit too high, and when Anthony stretched out number 38, gave him a friendly shove. That was Troy Carr, letting him know he was there. But had the ball been, a foot lower, it would have been another touchdown for Carroll. Incomplete pass, stops the clock, though. And we'll be at 2nd and 10 now from the 11-yard line. Griffith this time splits to the left side. He's already got one touchdown catch on the day. Rinker with 3 rushing touchdowns thus far. 2 backs will stay in the backfield to help block this time. Some pressure coming. Roach is dropping back. Throw the football. Touchdown. It's Griffith in the back of the end zone. And he just has a knack for getting open. You get the ball near him and he'll make the catch. And he just did it again. And another touchdown for Kyle Griffith and the Carroll College Fighting Saints. Comes with 9 seconds to play here in the second. Kyle Griffith, his 2nd touchdown, as I mentioned, of the day. Matt Roach having a great day. And the Saints, an extra point away from opening up a 27-point lead. Check that 23. Here's the extra point. It's on its way and it's good. 9 seconds to go, and Carroll in the end zone again. It's 35-12, Carroll. Reese with the extra point. The Saints did exactly what they wanted to, and that whole drive kept alive by a fake punt. A fourth and long, Reese Felton took the snap. Looked like he was going to try and pin the Coyotes inside their own 10 like he normally has been able to do all year long to their opponents. Instead, he just caught the ball, took off, and Durbin, right out in front of him, made a big, big block. So the Saints lead at 35-12. Remember, not long ago, at the 10:43 mark, actually, of the second quarter, it was 14-12. So in the last 10-plus minutes, Carroll has scored three times to blow this game open. All right, we're set to go. 9 seconds to go, number 83, Coulter Hamill. Tee it up. Scoot the ball low. It'll hit on the ground, take a bounce. And it's going to just barely roll across the goal line. That was close to a disaster for number 25 for College of Idaho, who could be, you would understand why Grant Darrington was down there blowing on that football, trying to get it to keep going, because if it dies at the 1 yard line, he might just turn it going into the locker room and not go to the sideline, because Coach not going to be very happy anyway. Worked out well for him. It's first and 10 for the Coyotes at the 25 yard line, and they trail 35-12, 9 seconds to go. Senior day here for Carroll College, the last conference game, home game, and conference game of the season for Carroll. And 19 seniors. TJ Gordon is going to give the ball to his big running back that time, isn't it? Teixeira, who's not going to get a lot. And that'll probably do it for the first half, it will. So there you have it. First two quarters are in the books. Carroll leads at 35-12. We're going to step away. And we'll be back close to the start of the second half with the first half statistics as we get ready for quarters 3 and 4.
Wow, it's a 2014 Ford Escape. Very sharp. EcoBoost, huh? That MPG will save some money. How about capability? Intelligent four-wheel drive? Perfect for our weather. Back here. Foot-activated liftgate. Oh, now that is smart. And now get up to $3,000 cash back on a new Escape with Sync and Sound. Or lease one for just $219 a month? It's the one for me. Reinvented for all, equipped for you, so you can go further. See your local Ford store today.
There are heroes all around us. Firefighters, emergency medical technicians, military and veterans, law enforcement, teachers, and healthcare workers. Select Realty thinks you deserve a break when buying, selling, or refinancing a home. We are the exclusive Homes for Heroes partner in the Helena area. We can provide extraordinary savings of up to $2,000. Call us or sign up today. Homes for Heroes can make a difference. Choices, choices, choices. Select Realty.
Visit Collision Pro online for the ultimate auto body experience. Find help in dealing with insurance questions as well as auto repair. From paint to parts to our armor coat protector, we have the information you're looking for. Check out real customer stories about Collision Pro's professionalism and quality service, and you can follow the progress of your car online. CollisionPro.com, your gateway to the ultimate auto body experience.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
Parents taught us how important it is to take care of one another. My father was an accountant and my mother worked for the school district, and together they took very good care of our family and our future. Today, I'm a father and a grandfather. It's important to plan for your loved ones so you don't have to worry about their futures. Call or stop by the Brad Schmidt Agency and together we can build a plan for you and your family. Take care of the next generation.
As a student, as an athlete, it is so important to stay focused.
I maintain my focus just by working my hardest in absolutely everything I do.
When you step on the mat, it's only you and another person, and making healthy choices is the first step.
Depending on what I eat, my nutrition, the people I hang out with, not using tobacco.
I don't think I'd be the person I am today if I had used tobacco products.
The community follows those teams that are respectful.
I love being a role model for kids all across the state.
I'm focused on a tobacco-free generation.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Check it out. The 2014 Ford F-150. Looks great, but let's build one for me. I need a 4x4 with plenty of power. Because back here, I'll be pulling my boat. Add some chrome, 18s, ooh, some fog lamps. Nice. The XLT 4x4. What's this? Just announced, get over $10,000 in total value on F-150 or lease one for $259 a month? Now just gotta choose a color. Ooh, black. The XLT F-150. Better hurry, it all ends soon.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
It's hard to be in college and not be focused.
Being an athlete even helps you become more and more focused.
If I don't stay focused, I fall way behind on schoolwork.
A lot of homework on the bus and in hotel room.
This is one of the most formational times in your life, and so it's important to make healthy choices.
Because people who are tobacco-free just do better in school.
I don't use tobacco. I feel like your body's your temple.
I don't think I'd be the person I am today if I had used tobacco products.
I'm focused on a tobacco-free generation.
Before you start your search
for the largest investment in your life, First Community Bank is here.
Pre-qualification is easy. In most cases, it's the same day.
For first-time home buyers and new construction.
Or your home away from home.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Office Solutions, for everything from office supplies, to office machines, to space design, to school supplies, even coffee and dogs. We are part of the largest wholesale buying group of office supplies in the country, which means you get the best of both worlds. National level pricing tied with local level service. Whether you walk in the store, order online, or work with our sales consultants, 360 Office Solutions is your answer. And we deliver smart answers everywhere you turn. 360 Office Solutions.
The Holiday Inn Conference Center downtown, Helena's only hotel on the historic walking mall. We offer everything you expect. Comfortable rooms, a large pool, and an up-to-date conference center. Plus, we're just steps away from shopping and dining. And we feature the Quarry Bar and Grill, Helena's ultimate sports bar. Contact the Holiday Inn today at 406-443-2200.
Hi, I'm Carly, front office manager here at the Holiday Inn downtown Helena. Come visit us for sleeping rooms and meeting rooms.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
Hard to be in college and not be focused.
Being an athlete even helps you become more and more focused.
If I don't stay focused, I fall way behind on schoolwork.
A lot of homework on the bus and in hotel room.
This is one of the most formational times in your life, and so it's important to make healthy choices.
Because people who are tobacco free just do better in school.
I don't use tobacco. I feel like your body is your temple.
I don't think I'd be the person I am today if I had used tobacco products.
I'm focused on a tobacco-free generation.
My parents taught us how important it is to take care of one another. My father was an accountant and my mother worked for the school district, and together they took very good care of our family and our future. Today, I'm a father and a grandfather. It's important to plan for your loved ones so you don't have to worry about their futures. Call or stop by the Brad Schmidt Agency and together we can build a plan for you and your family. Take care of
Plonk. It's a unique bar and restaurant in Bozeman. It was a big financial decision to find the right bank for our growing business. We decided on Opportunity Bank of Montana. They have great mobile banking, which is good because we're always on the go. I already had a home mortgage with them with great interest rates. We met with Bert, our new banker, our friend, and now we have a second restaurant in Missoula. It was a great opportunity.
Home Beautifiers is now a Hunter Douglas Gallery dealer. Visit our new showroom that showcases the newest in Hunter Douglas window coverings in full size that you can touch and feel. At Home Beautifiers, we promise an enjoyable and easy shopping experience, from initial design consultation to professional measuring and installation, all backed by the Hunter Douglas Lifetime Guarantee. We will make your home more inviting and beautiful.
Home Beautifiers, we make your house a home.
At MT Glass Liquor, we have an enormous selection of liquors to choose from at affordable prices. From specialty liquors to wines and mixers, our variety is second to none. If you're looking for a unique item, we have it in stock. As a Montana State liquor store, we offer wholesale prices and offer monthly sales. Our friendly, knowledgeable staff will help you pick out the perfect item for the right occasion. So stop in to MT Glass Liquor, your cocktail headquarters.
Wow, it's a 2014 Ford Escape. Very sharp. EcoBoost, huh? That MPG will save some money. How about capability? Intelligent four-wheel drive? Perfect for our weather. Back here. Foot-activated liftgate? Oh, now that is smart. And now get up to $3,000 cash back on a new Escape with Sync and Sound. Or lease one for just $219 a month? It's the one for me. Reinvented for all, equipped for you, so you can go further. See your local Ford store today.
Before you start your search
for the largest investment in your life, First Community Bank is here.
Pre-qualification is easy. In most cases, it's the same day.
For first-time home buyers and new construction.
Or your home away from home.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
My parents. It is to take care of one another. My father was an accountant and my mother worked for the school district, and together they took very good care of our family and our future. Today, I'm a father and a grandfather. It's important to plan for your loved ones so you don't have to worry about their futures. Call or stop by the Brad Schmidt Agency and together we can build a plan for you and your family. Take care of the next generation.
As a student, as an athlete, it is so important to stay focused.
When I'm not on the field, I'm in the classroom. When I'm not in the classroom, I'm in the breaks.
So you have to focus and prioritize what's important.
The choices I make on a day-to-day basis are huge. Not using tobacco, it all benefits who I am and who I am as a basketball player.
When you step on the mat, it's only you and another person, and making healthy choices is the first step.
Without making those healthy choices, I can be held back in my performance and I can hurt my team.
It's very important how the community sees you. I'm focused on a tobacco-free generation.
There are heroes all around us. Firefighters, emergency medical technicians, military and veterans, law enforcement, teachers, and healthcare workers. Select Realty thinks you deserve a break when buying, selling, or refinancing a home. We are the exclusive Homes for Heroes partner in the Helena area. We can provide extraordinary savings of up to $2,000. Call us or sign up today. Homes for Heroes can make a difference. Choices, choices, choices. Select Realty.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Barn Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
At MT Glass Liquor, we have an enormous selection of liquors to choose from at affordable prices. From specialty liquors to wines and mixers, our variety is second to none. If you're looking for a unique item, we have it in stock. As a Montana State liquor store, we offer wholesale prices and offer monthly sales. Our friendly, knowledgeable staff will help you pick out the perfect item for the right occasion. So stop in to MT Glass Liquor, your cocktail headquarters.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Barn Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
Check it out, the 2014 Ford F-150. Looks great, but let's build one for me. I need a 4x4 with plenty of power, because back here, I'll be pulling my boat. Add some chrome, 18s, ooh, some fog lamps, nice. The XLT 4x4, what's this? Just announced, get over $10,000 in total value on F-150, or lease one for $259 a month? Now just gotta choose a color. Ooh, black. The XLT F-150. Better hurry, it all ends soon.
Welcome back, everybody, to Nelson Stadium. Joe McMahon with you. It is halftime, almost completed halftime, as Carroll College in the coming out of the locker room, leading it 35-12. A solid, solid second half of the second quarter for Carroll has opened this game up. We'll recap the scoring thus far. Carroll on the board first, 11:59 to go in the first quarter with Dustin Rinker. One of three touchdowns in that first half, a three-yard run. Extra points good at 7-0. Then at the 6:40 mark of the first quarter, College of Idaho in the end zone for the first time. T.J. Gordon on a three-yard run. Extra point by Luke Taylor wide left, and it's 7-6 at that point. That's it for the first quarter. Second quarter, lots of scoring. 11:20 to go in quarter two. Carroll finds the end zone again. This time, Dustin Rinker on a two-yard run. The extra point from Matt Least was good. It was 14-6. At the 10:43 mark, though, College of Idaho answered right away, a 65-yard pass to Marcus Lenhart from T.J. Gordon. Extra point again wide left. It's 14-12. And the next three touchdowns, all Carroll. First one at the 9:08 mark. Rinker, another run this time from 3 yards out again. Extra point good. It's 21-12. That's at the 9:08 mark. At the 6:11 mark, Carroll in the end zone. A 27-yard pass from Mac Roach to Kyle Griffith. And the extra point was good. It's 28-12. And then Carroll tacked on one more right at the end of the second quarter. And that might be the killer. 9 seconds to go. An 11-yard pass to Griffith again from McElroy. So Griffith, two touchdowns on the day. Rinker with three thus far. Extra point from Reese was good. It's 35-12. And that's where we stand right now. Total points for the first half offensively. If you remember, it was a 2-1 time of possession advantage for College of Idaho at the end of the first quarter. Well, that's changed. Carroll has balanced that out a bit. Both teams have had the ball now for a total of 15 and a half minutes. So Carroll, big second quarter. Total yards, 180 for College of Idaho. Of those, 104 coming on the ground. For Carroll, 347 yards in the first half, 186 through the air, 161 on the ground. So talk about balance. First downs, 19 first downs for the Saints in the first half to just 6 for the Coyotes. And I guess we'll leave it at that. For Carroll, it's been a productive second quarter. And they'll get the ball to start quarter three. We're underway. It's Clark coming up to pick it up across the 20. And he'll weave his way to the 35-yard line, and that's where Carroll will start first and 10. So the Saint offense returns to the field, hitting it 35-12, up 23 points. Mac Roach, the junior starting quarterback this year, taking over for Dakota Stonehouse, and had a phenomenal year thus far. The Saints with a victory will wrap up Frontier Conference number 14 in the 15 years that Mike Van Deest has been here. It'll be their 14th conference title. Rinker tries to push it to the outside and tack on some more yards, and there he goes. Avoids another tackle in midfield to 40, still on his feet, 30. They finally push him out of bounds and spotted the 30-yard line. So he takes off from the 35, gets down to the other end and the 30-yard line. About a 35-yard run hit. That'll put him close to 100 yards on the day. And more importantly, it puts Carroll in great position here. So Rinker, first play of the second half, takes off down the sideline, right side. Jordan Pine will check in, give Dustin a chance to catch his breath. Pine with a huge first half as well. He had 62 yards. Roach is going to roll to the right on a first and 10, set up a screen, and unable to complete it to Pine. Set up pretty well, but pretty good pressure that time defensively by the College of Idaho defensive front, and one of their linebackers. Mac Roach really had to get rid of that ball a little sooner than he wanted to. Saying nothing there, he threw the ball on the ground, and they'll live to run another down. Not a place where you want to turn it over. Interception there, and it's pick six for the Coyotes. Just underway here in the second half. Carroll with a victory, looking for that conference title and also to host a playoff game next week. The pairings will be announced Sunday evening. Pine, this time stutter steps at the line of scrimmage, breaks a tackle, ducks under, picks up. And it looked like they're going to hold him for a gain of one or two. He's got seven. Tackle made by number 13, Jordan Jacobs. Give him seven on the carry. That'll be second down and three as Rinker comes back in. He'll give Pine a break. Rinker now 16 attempts, 102 yards of the day. He's averaging 137 yards a game. Well on his way to picking that up today. Here comes Kyle Griffith in with the next play. Kyle, a big day already. Two touchdown passes for the sophomore from Kalispell, Montana. He'll be in the slot left side with Clark split wide to that side. Now in motion, back towards the formation. Roach will drop back to look to throw the football down the field. Lots of time, all kinds of time, and he's going to throw it away. Great coverage that time by the Coyotes. College of Idaho secondary. Outstanding job of staying with those receivers. So it is fourth down now for Carroll. Imagine they'll go for it here. It's ball spotted on the 23, which means it would be about a 40-yard field goal attempt. Matt Weiss with a field goal attempt in the first half that didn't work out so well. So it's fourth down for the Coyotes. They got to get a stop here. They're going to bring some pressure off the corner. Fire incomplete. Roach bounced the football into the hands of Simak. He's trying to sell it as a catch, but the official said, saw it skip across the turf. So he had Simak open, but that time Roach misfired. So on downs, the Coyotes get the football back, and they'll start from their own 22-yard line. Again, in the first half, 104 yards, 104 on the ground for College of Idaho. And through the air, TJ Gordon, 5 of 8, 76 yards and a touchdown. Bulk of that came on the 58-yard pass to his tight end that led to their second score of the game. First down, Gordon's going to keep it, get to the outside, evade a couple of tacklers. They'll push him out of bounds after a gain of 10, but number 96 had a hand on him, but couldn't corral him. Brian Grotman, the senior, couldn't bring him to the ground. He steps out of bounds right at the marker, and it's enough for a first down, so give TJ Gordon 10 yards on that carry. Saints lead it 35-12, 13-17 to play here in quarter two. Joe McMahon with you from Nelson Stadium on the campus of Carroll College in Helena, Montana, on a sunny day in the capital. Teixeira running the ball straight ahead, runs into Shane Durbin and just keeps pushing his way ahead. After the initial contact, he bowled his way ahead for another 3 or 4 yards, still running hard. Number 42 for Carroll, Durbin in on that tackle. He had the initial contact. He got some help, but Teixeira picked up 8, almost 9 yards. It'll be second and short for the Coyotes from Caldwell, Idaho. Again, averaging at home 4,500 fans, which is just amazing. Teixeira just went off the sideline. I see him over there. He's having some work problems. He's crouched down. Missed much of the first half after being injured. So here we go, right side. His replacement, number 23. Check that, Rizzoli was his replacement. Picks up 4 yards. Zach Garzoli, number 33, the freshman from Orland, California. So it is first down. They pick up the first down up near midfield. They're on their own 45-yard line. They trail 35-12. Garzoli in the backfield with Gordon, and he'll get the ball off right tackle. Shane Durbin there to make this stop, but not until Rizzoli picks up 5 yards. So this young offensive front for the College of Idaho, doing a great job of controlling the line of scrimmage so far. They have one senior, and that's their center, Greg Dolman. The rest of them are all freshmen on that offensive front. Twin receivers to the left side, single man to the right. Gordon's running speed option left side, and he gets drilled. I'd say that's probably Bloomquist for the way he went down and how quickly that defender closed on him. That's got to be Sean Bloomquist, and it was. Senior linebacker just came firing through there, and TJ Gordon was thinking about pitching the ball. About the time Sean Bloomquist closed on him and then he was on the ground. Great play by the senior, another tackle for loss. Again, Bloomquist makes his living in that department. He had a pile of them last year. 19 of them out with 124 total tackles, and he's well on his way to similar statistics this year. So it is third and long, and in the College of Idaho, realizing this is an important play, is going to take a timeout. So timeout on the field, 35-12, our score, Carroll in the lead.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Before you start your search
for the largest investment in your life, First Community Bank is here.
Pre-qualification is easy. In most cases, it's the same day.
For first-time home buyers and new construction.
Or your home away from home.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Back, everybody. Nelson Stadium, Joe McMahon with you. Carroll averaging 37 points a game. Their opponents today, the Coyotes, 26 points per game. First downs, 23 for Carroll in the season to 21 for the Coyotes. And total offense, pretty close. 454 yards a game for the Saints, 391 for our College of Idaho. But good point made during our break. Fourth down conversions. Up until that last fourth down attempt by Carroll, they were at 100%. And that'll offset that. Either they don't go for it very often and only on gimmies, or great job by the College of Idaho defense that time. TJ Gordon drops back on the third and long, getting some pressure. He's going to roll to his left, trying to pick it up with his legs. Dakota Amy pushes him out of bounds. He's going to be short of that stick, so he's at midfield. He got across the 50 down to the 49, but he needed to get to about the 45-yard line of Carroll. Didn't get there, so it's going to be fourth and about four, call it. What are they going to do? They leave their offense on the field. And really, you're down 35-12. Tough call for the coaching staff. What do you do here? You definitely don't want to go down by another score, but so they'll reset the football. Oh, check that. I see what's going on. We got a penalty, and I missed that. It's a holding call, and Carroll took the penalty. So they're going to repeat the down. It'll be third down now. Back it up from the spot of the infraction. I did not see the flag. I missed that. I apologize. 35-12 is the score. The ball now at the 37-yard line. They need to get to the St. 45-yard line for a first down. So it's fourth and a bunch. Fourth and about 17. Fourth down conversions, or third down conversions for the Coyotes on the season are right at 43%. Gordon this time, he'll drop straight back, pressure coming from the backside. He'll get rid of it before it arrives, and the ball's out and complete. Nice job. The receiver catches the ball and picks up the first down. Well run, well thrown ball, and Austin Diffie made the catch and the picked up the necessary yardage after the catch. Carroll, pretty good coverage, but TJ Gordon threw a strike, and Diffie caught the football. Got down far enough, picks up about 18 yards, and it's a first down. Mike Van Deest, even though he's up 35-12, not happy about what he just saw. He's telling one of the secondary guys who just came off the field, Dawson Osborne, about it. Gordon, some pressure, he's going to go down there. Nope, he avoids one guy, but up. That's it right there. They got him wrapped up, so the whistle will blow the play down. Getting his paws on him and ending the scramble that time with Shane Durbin. So it's a sack for the Saints, a loss of about five. Make it six, so it'll be second down and 16. Carroll 8-1 on the season, looking for their ninth straight win after opening the season with a loss to Southern Oregon, a game that they led late and let slip away. They avenged that loss, however, with a victory over Southern Oregon on October 18th. They beat them 42-40 right here at Nelson Stadium. Two receivers to the left side, second and long. TJ Gordon, and they're going to stop this play before we get started. I would imagine this is a procedure call against the Coyotes. False start again. Yep, false start on the Coyotes. Second of those today for College of Idaho, of Caldwell, Idaho. A defensive front for Carroll again, putting together another great effort led by the seniors, Dakota Amy, Sean Condon, and Brian Rotman. Jeff Gweck, the junior, in there quite a bit as well. But right now it's Rotman, Condon, and Amy. And we got a timeout. Another timeout called by the College of Idaho on a critical second down. So something wasn't right. That's their second of the half, I believe. So timeout on the field, 35-12, Carroll.
It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
I maintain my focus just by working my hardest in absolutely everything I do.
In the classroom, on the court, at practice, wherever you're at.
My classes are very rigorous.
At the same time, you need to be able to stay focused and make the right choices and stay on top of it. Tobacco use would definitely be a negative effect on a student athlete.
Using tobacco really decreases the performance of any athlete.
I wouldn't be able to dance. I wouldn't be able to hang out with my friends. I wouldn't be able to hike the up. I think that it would make me less of a focused student.
Distract me from my sport, distract me from my academics.
I'm focused on a tobacco-free generation.
So out of the timeout, a second and long for College of Idaho back at Nelson Stadium. Everybody, Joe McMahon with you. Second and 22. Second and a bus ride, as a friend of mine used to say. Near midfield, two receivers split out to the left side. Full backfield, Gordon's looking left. Fire the football, complete. The Diffie, not enough for the first down, but it picked up a big chunk of what they needed. Got it back, Diffie. Austin Diffie, a great receiver. Freshman out of Eagle, Idaho, ran another strong route, and TJ Gordon found him, and they'll pick up about 19 of the 22 yards they needed, so it's 3rd and 3. And actually, they're probably in 4-down territory right here, so a couple of snaps there to pick up the 3 yards. Keep an eye on that tight end for the Yotes, who's flanked to the right side. And they're going to give the ball to their running back, who slips as he gets to the line of scrimmage. He thought about changing directions, and what he did is feet on that frozen field went out from under him a little bit. He lost his footing. That, again, is number 46, Ryan Teixeira, 230-pound running back. And he went nowhere. So it's 4th down. Big 4th down. As I suspected, it is 4th down territory here. They're going to keep their offense on the field. See if they can pick this up and keep this drive alive. With 7:24 to go in the quarter. They trailed by 23 points. They don't want to give the Carroll offense the ball back. They'll send number 80 wide to the left side. That's Zach Cooper. Will they run the football? No, Gordon's going to try and get it himself. He'll spin after the initial hit, and I don't think he got it. I think Carroll figured he was going to try and pick it up himself, and they were right. In good coverage, Dakota Amy was there to turn him around. Jake Conan came up on that play, and of course, the ever-present Sean Bloomquist up there to help make that stop as well. So good job of the team that time for making that stop. Conan getting some more coaching when he comes off the field from Van Deest. He looks like he's angry. Come on, coach, and he stopped him on a 4th down. So it is first and 10 for Carroll. The Yotes turn the ball over on downs. Two backs in the backfield flanking Mac Roach. We'll give it to Rinker, trying to get to the corner. Good block from the inman. Rinker turns the corner, and here he goes. He is across midfield, still on his feet, outrunning a couple of defenders. Anthony Clark to make a block, and Rinker's going to score. So Justin Rinker shows why he has been one of the top running backs in NAIA history. As he goes from the 32-yard line, runs it into the end zone, a run of 68 yards for Rinker, and not what the Coyotes wanted to see after getting their last possession stopped. So a 68-yard run. Rinker in the end zone for the fourth time today. It comes at the 6:50 mark here at quarter number three. And Matt Wiest again on to attempt that extra point. Reese Felton will place it for him. The ball's down, the kick's on its way, and it is good. Timeout on the field, our score. Carroll 42, College of Idaho 12.
At MT Glass Liquor, we have an enormous selection of liquors to choose from at affordable prices. From specialty liquors to wines and mixers, our variety is second to none. If you're looking for a unique item, we have it in stock. As a Montana State liquor store, we offer wholesale prices and offer monthly sales. Our friendly, knowledgeable staff will help you pick out the perfect item for the right occasion. So stop in to MT Glass Liquor, your cocktail headquarters.
An accident can ruin your day, and you're going to need all the help you can get. Help, I Crashed My Car is an app for your phone that'll give you that help. Based on GPS technology, Help, I Crashed My Car makes contacting the police, emergency services, tow truck, and your family members quick and easy. To add Help, I Crashed My Car to your phone, visit collisionpro.com and click on the command to download the app, and you'll be set. Collision Pro is here to help you get your car back on the road.
So Dustin Rinker takes the handoff. First play of that possession. Second possession of the half is the first play of that. And Rinker goes 68 yards. Anthony Clark with a big block downfield. But another block thrown at the line of scrimmage that sprung him loose. And I missed the number of the kid out in front there. But great job, Rinker. Read the blocks perfectly. Got to the outside, showed his speed. And he now has 17 carries, 170 yards, ladies and gentlemen. Big day for Dustin Rinker, averaging 132 in a game. He's well over that right now. Up ahead on the return, number two, scoots across the 30-yard line. That is Corey Brady. And they stop him as he gets to the 35-yard line, and that's where the Yotes will start first and 10. Yote offense, a little slow coming out of the field. Here they come. So the Saints, they'll start with a four-man front. They'll alternate that. You see them oftentimes with three guys up there. They're going to try and stop the run here. Gordon's got it. He's going to pitch back to Teixeira. And Durbin makes the tackle after Teixeira rumbles ahead for a gain of about seven. So a big run that time and a gain of seven. They've been able to move the ball from time to time on the ground, but Carroll offensively, they scored on some big plays to open this game up. Gordon's going to drop back, look to throw the football, and Durbin gets a hand on it. Oh, and laying on the ground, almost making the interception. It's number four for Carroll. He's laying there, and the ball just about lands in his lap. That's James Dalgan. Durbin tipped it. Dalgan just in the right spot. Definitely not expecting the ball to hit him in the chest. Most rushing touchdowns in a single game, Carroll College. Five is the record, and it's been done by quite a few different players. Most recently, Dearcorn in 2003. But Mike Morris in 99 had five. Rogum in 97 had five. Right now, the reason we bring that up is Dustin Rinker has four today. And we are halfway through, a little over halfway through the quarter, third quarter. What do we got here? Got to delay a game on the offense. Obviously on the offense, you really can't have it on the defense. So they'll step it back. And instead of third and two, it's 37, 38. 42-12, Carroll looking to start their march to through the playoffs next week here at home. Again, the pairings will be announced Sunday evening, as it looks like Carroll will secure their ninth win of the season and their conference title, Frontier Conference title. To Gordon, no place to go. Sean Conn just played it perfectly, stayed at home, didn't follow the back coming across. Number 94 right there with him, both of those guys. That's Kyle Smith. He and Condon stood their ground. And as soon as TJ Gordon pulled the ball out away from the running back, they're standing there waiting for him. He has no place to go. In fact, he'll lose a yard. So it's fourth and nine. Carroll defense has given up 12 points. And they don't give up much more than that per game. That's about it. So into punt football again for the College of Idaho is number 36, Kevin McLemore. Junior out of Simi Valley, California. Moore Park Community College, a transfer. Not sure what's going on. Oh, we got another delay game? We do. Sometimes when your punt team's on the field, a delay game is planned. That time, nope. You take a delay game if you want to back it up and give your punter a little better angle to get the balls down inside the 10 and have it die there. But right now, he's lined up on his 16-yard line. So puts together a fairly good punt. It'll be Clark. He'll field it on his 30-yard line. Gets a couple great blocks, turns it upfield. Sees a seam, and off he goes. Gets to the outside, still going. He's got one man to beat. And he can't get around him. Good job. A touchdown save and tackle by number 7. But Clark gets down to the 30-yard line before Levi Ellsbury makes the tackle. Clark just turned that right up the seam, saw a seam, and took off. Good block thrown that time by number 44 for Carroll, and that's Daniel Simons. He's one of their defensive linemen. He's in and out there a few times on the defensive front, but he also is a terrific special teams player. So, just what the College of Idaho did not want Carroll to have, a short field, they have. First and 10 from the Coyote 30-yard line. Carroll already up by 30. It's 42-12. Roach will drop straight back. Fire that football wide open is number 86, touchdown Carroll. A 30-yard strike from Mac Roach to number 86, Stephen Delaney. And Carroll is approaching the 50-point mark here. It is now Carroll 48 and College of Idaho 12. Great throw by Mac Roach. So Matt Lees, who has had a workout today, on to attempt another extra point. He's been perfect thus far, and I hope I didn't just jinx him by saying so, but he's been very accurate. After each score, the National Guardsmen fire off that cannon. They're running out of ammunition here. Extra point up and good. Timeout on the field from Nelson Stadium. The Saints 49, College of Idaho 12.
Check it out. The 2014 Ford F-150. Looks great, but let's build one for me. I need a 4x4 with plenty of power. Because back here, I'll be pulling my boat. Add some chrome, 18s. Ooh, some fog lamps. Nice. The XLT 4x4. What's this? Just announced, get over $10,000 in total value on F-150, or lease one for $259 a month? Now just gotta choose a color. Ooh, black. The XLT F-150. Better hurry, it all ends soon.
Before you start your search
for the largest investment in your life, First Community Bank is here.
Prequalification is easy. In most cases, it's the same day.
For first-time home buyers and new construction,
or your home away from home.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Back at Nelson Stadium, it's been 35-0 since it was 14-12 in the second quarter. The Coyotes looking to turn that around. A kickoff is Brady. He gets across the 20-yard line. And Carroll will stack him up and put him down right there at the 22-yard line. On the tackle for the Fighting Saints from Carroll College, number 20, Robert Sharps. Along with number 30 in on that tackle, Ty Irving. So it's first and 10 from the 23-yard line. They'll spot it. And we'll see. As we roll through the rest of this third quarter, and folks, we still have almost 5 minutes to play. But as we move into the fourth quarter, if it'll be time to see some of these seniors who don't get a lot of playing time, give them an opportunity to play here on senior day. College of Idaho at the line of scrimmage, and the officials stop play for a second. Not sure why. Oh, it can't be another delay game. Well, we'll find out. Well, actually, it could be, but this would be the third of the second half. Yeah, it is. Play again. So, I don't know. Just things not going well for College of Idaho here in quarter number three, as the Saints just opened this game up. Gordon's going to step back. We got a new quarterback, number 18. He's going to throw the football down the field, and the ball is tipped. Knocked loose. In throwing the football is Jake Hennessy. We got a flag down there. There was some contact before the ball arrived. I was wondering if we were going to see that yellow hanky. And so changing quarterback, Jake Hennessy, the 6-foot sophomore from Mountain Home, Idaho, into the game. Threw that football. Incomplete, but play won't count. They'll take the penalty. Looked like some incidental contact. Coach Van Diest is talking to the side judge about it. Regardless, it's an automatic first down, so they'll move the ball ahead up to the 33 and a half yard line. First and 10 for the Coyotes. A little bit of wind out of the east. Not much at all, however. Sunny day here in the capital city is number 31 on the carry. He's going nowhere, and that's Kyle Merritt. Merritt, I believe that's his first carry. He's a junior from Irvine, California. Bloomquist with the tackle. Another tackle for loss for Sean. Bloomquist, the only senior linebacker for Carroll, that plays quite a bit. All the rest are underclassmen. Conan and Durbin, both juniors. This time they'll look to the right and sack from behind by number 96, Ryan Grotman, is Jake Hennessy. So Hennessy on the second snap found out what TJ Gordon's been dealing with all day, pressure. It's Ryan Grotman, the senior, came firing around the right end and got that sack. So a big play for Brian, senior from Great Falls, Montana, CMR High School. Former wrestler, CMR wrestlers defeated Helena High here in the capital city. Last night, we'll play for that state title game up in Kalispell against Glacier High School next week. Congratulations to the wrestlers. Trips to the left this time. Is Gordon back in there? Nope. And the ball comes out. The ball's on the ground, picked up by the running back, and he's going nowhere. So things are just falling apart. They put Jake Hennessy in there. He's sacked on his second play. Third play. Or sacked on his second play. Third play, he gets hit, drops the ball loose. So it's going to bring up fourth down, fourth and two. So McLemore back to punt again with Anthony Clark waiting this punt. He's got some help back there. Jared Marinick's going to join him on about the 40-yard line. They'll wait. There's the snap as Carroll sets up a return. And McLemore will punt the football away. It'll be Marinick making the catch. He'll turn it upfield, gets to the outside. There he goes. Two Yotes missed him, and he slipped near midfield. Otherwise, he might still be running, coming up from behind, but really not touching him was Malik Whitfield. But it'll be Carroll ball, first and 10 near midfield. 49-12, 2:17 to go. Here comes Mac Roach in that first team offense. Coach Howlett, Coach Van Beest keeping their foot on the throttle here as the Saints in their final tune-up before next week's playoff round starts. And we anticipate a home playoff game for the Saints. It's Rinker, he'll turn the ball up the field. No, excuse me, Jordan Pine turns the ball inside across midfield. Nice run by Pine that time. He'll pick up about 6 yards, and that'll give Jordan, let's add it up for you, 75 yards on the game. Right now, Dustin Rinker has 170 yards. His long of the day, a 68-yard rumble just moments ago. So it is second and 4 for Carroll. Pine will float to the right side. Roach will throw it back this way to Marinick on a bubble screen. It evades one tackler, and he is off to the races. Poor job of tackling that time by number 42. Josh Bielma was right there with him, but really had an opportunity to drop him right at the line of scrimmage and missed him, and he's coming off right now. So another first down for Carroll as Marinick picks up about 12 yards on that pass play. Clark to the right. Marinick split to the left, and the slot left is Zymak. And again, this time it is Rinker. There he goes. Excuse me, Pine. Pine down inside the 10-yard line. Touchdown, Carroll. So Jordan Pine finds the end zone. And for Carroll, more scoring. Jordan Pine in the end zone, this time at the 1:13 mark of the quarter. And it officially, folks, is a blowout. Pine's first touchdown of the day. Puts him near 100 yards, actually over 100 yards for the day. Matt Wieston to attempt his extra point. We've seen this a few times. Reese Felton will place the ball for him. There's the snap, the placement, and the kick is on its way, and it is perfect. 1:13 to play, 55-12, Carroll.
Home Beautifiers is now a Hunter Douglas Gallery dealer. Visit our new showroom that showcases the newest in Hunter Douglas window coverings in full size that you can touch and feel. At Home Beautifiers, we promise an enjoyable and easy shopping experience, from initial design consultation to professional measuring and installation, all backed by the Hunter Douglas Lifetime Guarantee. We will make your home more inviting and beautiful.
Home Beautifiers, we make your house a home.
360 Office Solutions, for everything from office supplies, to office machines, to space design, to school supplies, even coffee, and dogs. We are part of the largest wholesale buying group of office supplies in the country, which means you get the best of both worlds. National level pricing tied with local level service. Whether you walk in the store, order online, or work with our sales consultants, 360 Office Solutions is your answer. And we deliver smart answers everywhere you turn. 360 Office Solutions.
Carroll, 310 exactly. Two running backs with over 100 yards. 108 right now for Jordan Pine, 170 for Dustin Rinker. And it's a blowout, 56-12. And a little trickery attempted here by College of Idaho, and folks, it's not looking good. Number 3 has the football. He's still on his pin somehow, but he's going down. As down to make the stop is number 83 for Carroll on Isaac Gonzalez. For Carroll, that's Coulter Hamill, actually. The kicker came down and made that tackle, but... First and 10 for the College of Idaho Coyotes, who have made some substitutions in the last series that really didn't pay off too well. They changed quarterbacks. And actually, I thought T.J. Gordon was doing a pretty good job, but Jake Hennessy came in trying to get some playing time. Let's see who's under center this trip out. It is Hennessy again. 6'0", 6-foot sophomore, 190-pounder from Mountain Home, Idaho. Carroll with a four-man front, expecting them to run the football. Hennessy's going to do just that. Hand off to number 33, who doesn't have a lot of room. That's Garzoli, freshman from Orland, California. He'll pick up two, maybe 3 yards. Carroll stacks him up at the line of scrimmage. Number 31 in there for Carroll. So we might start to see some substitutions. Eric Dawson in there to make that tackle. Number 94, we see him in there. It's Kyle Smith. So he's getting some playing time now. Number 37 also playing right now. That's Gus Sommerfeld. He's a 6'2", 235-pound defensive end from Vaughn, Montana. So, Coach Grandis starting to make some defensive substitutions. As Hennessy fires it out into the flat, complete to his tight end, who's run out of bounds by number 19 after a short game. And that's Tucker. So with the catch, number 85, Marcus Lenhardt, who has a touchdown catch on the day already. Short game. It'll be third down. And six. And that is the end of the quarter. That's the last play of quarter three. Carroll all over College of Idaho. It's 14-12 at one point. Now it's 56-12. We'll be back.
Wow, it's a 2014 Ford Escape. Very sharp. EcoBoost, huh? That MPG will save some money. How about capability? Intelligent four-wheel drive? Perfect for our weather. Back here. Foot-activated liftgate. Oh, now that is smart. And now get up to $3,000 cash back on a new Escape with Sync and Sound. Or lease one for just $219 a month? It's the one for me. Reinvented for all, equipped for you, so you can go further. See your local Ford store today.
There are heroes all around this. Firefighters, emergency medical technicians, military and veterans, law enforcement, teachers, and healthcare workers. Select Realty thinks you deserve a break when buying, selling, or refinancing a home. We are the exclusive Homes for Heroes partner in the Helena area. We can provide extraordinary savings of up to $2,000. Call us or sign up today. Homes for Heroes can make a difference. Choices, choices, choices. Select Realty.
Over the PA system and being serenaded down below by all the crowd. It is not Sweet Montana for College of Idaho right now, as they are getting blasted 56-12 here at Nelson Stadium. 14-12 is our score, and that was back at the 10:43 mark of quarter number two. And that came right after TJ Gordon hit Marcus Lenhardt on a 58-yard pass completion and run. Extra point, no good. It was 14-12, and since then, it's been all Carroll. They have outscored College of Idaho 42-0 since then. So I guess you could say safely that's a turning point in the game. They came right back, went right down the field and scored, and it's been six touchdowns in a row from that point on for Carroll. So Hennessy will roll to his right. Here comes some pressure, and he's going nowhere. The ball's out, and I think Carroll has it. Ball came out as he was going down. This may very well be Carroll football down in Coyote territory. As Lenhardt, the tight end's walking off the field, he thinks Carroll has it, and they do. Number 45 was right there to make that tackle. Austin Ybarra, a sophomore linebacker out of Fullerton, Colorado. Here he comes. He came in behind on the play when the ball came out. He was on top of it. Like a second grader on Halloween candy. He was just all over that thing. So it is Carroll ball again, first and 10 in Yote territory, and we have some changes offensively. Number 17, JT Linder from the huge metropolis of Dillon, Montana, in under center. Pine, the tailback. Linder getting an opportunity to play here in the fourth quarter. Carroll up big. Pine's gonna tiptoe at the line of scrimmage and now accelerate, turn it inside. Not much, maybe 3 yards on the carry, but a big day for Jordan Pine, a career day for him on senior day. He has 111 yards now on the ground. 111 yards and a touchdown. Rinker, 170 yards and four touchdowns. And you could see it starting early on in the game. Carroll was getting big chunks of yards, and it's just continued. They have 310 yards on the ground and 230 yards through the air. So I'm pretty good at math. 540 total yards already. So Linder under center with a tight end lined up on his right side. The single man in the backfield is Pine. He'll give it to, no, he'll fake it to Jordan. Roll to his left, looking to throw it to his tight end. They never do that, they just did. And number 82 with the reception, that is Nate Heinrichs. And he's down inside the 10-yard line, spotted at the 5. So a rarely used, rarely called play, pass play to a tight end results in a huge gain down to the 5-yard line. So Linder, the sophomore from Dillon, Montana, 6'2", 195-pounder, involved in some state championship games for the Beaverhead County High School football team back in his high school days. Gets a chance here to show what he can do, and he's going to hand the ball to Pine. That's usually a pretty good idea. Jordan, touchdown. Jordan with his second touchdown, this one a 5-yard run. And that comes at the 13:33 mark here of quarter number 4. So Matt Weiss back out on the field. As it is now, 62-12. Carroll looking to, there's 60, about to be 62-12, and Weiss puts this extra point through. And it is. So the extra point is up and good. Timeout on the field. Carroll 62, College of Idaho 12.
Visit Collision Pro online for the ultimate auto body experience. Find help in dealing with insurance questions as well as auto repair. From paint to parts to our Armor Co protector, we have the information you're looking for. Check out real customer stories about Collision Pro's professionalism and quality service, and you can follow the progress of your car online. CollisionPro.com, your gateway to the ultimate auto body experience.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style, your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
Nelson Stadium on the campus of Carroll College in Helena, Montana. Carroll, all over College of Idaho, 62-12 with well over 13 minutes still to play in this game. And really, Coach Van Deest, since the late in the third quarter, has played backups on both sides of the football. So it's not as if they're purposely running it up on the visitors from Caldwell, Idaho, who have had a pretty good season. They're 3-6 in conference, 4-6 overall. They are obviously going to get their 7th loss here today. And this will propel Carroll into a playoff next week, probably Saturday, about noonish, I would say, right here at Nelson Stadium. The pairings to be announced for NAIA for that first round on Sunday evening. Ball in the air. And the return man catches it. Now he's going to bring it out. Well, no, he's not. He's not going anywhere. He's going to get stopped before he comes out of the end zone. And it's just going from bad to worst here, folks. He touched the ball, went into the end zone, picked it up. The officials are going to talk about this. They're not even sure what it is. It's obviously not good. But Coach Van Deest is telling him it's a safety. And now they're going to call it a touchback. They'll bring it back out to the 20-yard line and start first and 10. Coach Van Deest is believing that's a safety because it was touched before it went in. Looking for an explanation from the side judge. He didn't get what he wanted, and he's not very happy. But, Coach, you're up by, actually 50, so it's going to be all right. Just go back there. Down back over there. It's okay. So it's first and 10 for the Coyotes from their own 25-yard line. And coming out to run the offense this time, again, it'll be Hennessy. He took over midway through the third quarter for T.J. Gordon. Throw it out into the flat to Diffie. Good catch there, but a tackle quickly made by number 20. He's getting some playing time for Carroll, and that is Robert Sharps. Sharps came up to make that tackle. So through the third quarter, Carroll, 544 total yards. That's a lot. 234 yards for the Coyotes. Carroll, of those 544, 314 on the ground. And they have 24 first downs compared to 10 for College of Idaho. Tennessee this time operates out of the gun. The running back's on either hip. He's going to keep it. Turn the corner. Good read that time. Gets out of bounds. Runs through the Carroll bench.
Tennessee has a carry forced out of bounds by Robert Sharps.
Sharps runs him out of bounds, but not before he picks up enough yardage for that first down. So they'll move the chain on the far side. Reset it. And it will be first and 10 for the Coyotes. So Teixeira leads the team on the ground, 49 yards for him, 39 for Gordon, who's out of the game now. And for Carroll, two backs over 100 yards, 170 yards for Dustin Rinker on 17 tries, 9 tries and 117 yards for Jordan Pine. Tennessee's going to fire the football out into the flat, complete to number 40. A gain of about 9, close to that first down is Ringo Robinson. I like that one. Ringo Robinson with the reception. Second and 1. Look along that defensive front for Carroll, and you see kids like number 37, Gus Sommerfeld, who I mentioned in there, getting some playing time. Daniel Simons is in there, number 44. Kids you don't see a lot of, don't get a lot of playing time. They're playing behind some pretty good ball players. Eric Dawson's in there, the linebacker. There is the snap, and at the line of scrimmage, brought down by Bogomil, is the quarterback Hennessy, and he is short of the first down. Bogomil, wearing number 12 today, stepped in from that linebacker position, and it's going to be third and short. Third and about a yard. One of those games where they're just kind of playing out the last 11 minutes. The outcome has been decided. As Carroll has outscored College of Idaho 50-0 since it was 14-12. And I don't think Hennessy's going to get it. Nope, they're going to turn him back. But second team defense has a bit of pride. They're saying, not on our stop. We're not going to let you do it. So they turn him around. Number 37 in on that tackle. Sommerfeld again. The 235-pound junior defensive end from Vaughn, Montana. And a big push there, big play. Zeke Kozlowski also in there for Carroll. Sophomore out of Dillon, Montana. Three-man front for Carroll. Fourth and short. Tennessee going to do? Nope, he's going to look to throw the football. Complete. Completing a first down. Didn't need much, and they didn't get much. But number 2 made the tackle for Carroll. Zach Salcedo, a senior. But enough for the first down on the reception. And that'll move the chain. So there's some positive progress for the Coyotes. Crowd's thinned out a bit. As Hennessy will drop back, here comes some pressure. He'll fire the football, intercepted. You can see that coming. Playing center field was the safety. He just stepped up and caught that football. And he's got an interception, and that's number 19 with the pick for Carroll College. That's Greg Tucker. Tucker just playing center field, saw the ball, saw Hennessy watching his receiver the entire way, read the quarterback's eyes. As soon as that ball was released, he stepped right up in front of the receiver and was in the perfect place. So, turnover, interception, and Carroll steps right back onto the field offensively, and when they come out this time, they'll bring Dylan Green as their tailback. Dylan has not played at all today. He is a junior running back out of Greeley, Colorado. Checked out a sophomore from Riverside, Washington. Reading the wrong list there. And there he goes, Green, straight ahead. Getting some push. Picks up a couple of yards. So Green, his first carry of the day. I don't think we'll see Rinker the rest of the day, and probably Pine sparingly. Carroll, with no intent of running the score up on their opponent. Mike Van Deest, very aware of that. At some point in their coaching careers, all coaches have been on the other end of that. Wide to the right comes Delaney, with Linder at the line of scrimmage, set to go. letting that play clock run down. He'll get it down to about five before he snaps the football. He'll turn this time, give it to Green, left side, cut it inside, and there he goes. Just seems like whoever they put in there, off they go. And this time Green picks up 14, 15 yards before being literally tripped up by Corey Brady. So Dylan Green getting a chance to carry the football. Just a little guy, or a short man, 5'9", 225 pounder though, sophomore from Riverside, Washington. It is always amazing in this Carroll College Fighting Saint football team how they just plug new guys in and they just keep going. It's like changing a light bulb. Off they go. Credit to the staff. Andy Ritter in there. He's in the slot right to the right side, a product of Butte Central High School. And it's Green, left side again. More yardage. Contact, and he'll push his way ahead. Contact at 3 yards in. Pushes his way up. Picks up about 6 yards. So second and four for the Saints with under 9 to play. And if you're College of Idaho, again, a great first quarter, and they've played well in the first quarter all year long, outscoring their opponents, but the last 3 quarters have been disastrous, especially the second quarter. And today, it's been really bad. First quarter, hung right there. It was 7-6, then 14-12, and then Carroll just took off. Linder. Gives it to Green again, outside, just off tackle, left side. They've run the same play 3 times, and this time he'll pick up 6 more yards. So really, Nick Holland doing what he can to hold the score down, running the same play 3 straight times off the left side. But you're facing a College of Idaho team that's very young, inexperienced, and tired right now. Not a lot of depth. But they will be back. This team loaded with underclassmen. I mean loaded with sophomores and freshmen. Keep them in school, keep them in the area during off-season, because that's a big part of the Frontier Conference, what you do during the off-season. Got a bright future. Green, tiptoeing at the line of scrimmage, cuts it back inside, slips, and down he goes. Pick up a yard or two before Corey Brady brings him down. Freshman from Boise, Idaho. So a couple of yards there. Second and about 8. For Carroll, here comes number 47, Nick Edens. Don't see him very often. Or excuse me, Aaron Worth. Aaron Worth, he's a senior. I mentioned him during the break that I listed as a senior running back, but I haven't seen him play much. And there he is. He gets onto the field. What a great moment for him, the senior running back on senior day. Steps into the lineup and he's going to get the football. He's going to turn it back inside and there he goes. He's off and running. He's inside the 30-yard line. They don't get him until he gets down to the 20-yard line. So Worth takes off from the 40. He picks up 22 yards on his first carry of the season. Aaron Worth. Big moment for him. Looked at and you see Aaron out there, you note that leg brace, that knee brace on the left leg, so obviously he's had some injuries that he's been working with. He's slowing down right there. He's going to stay on the game. Aaron Worth, senior tailback. Linder, this time turns, gives it to Worth. He'll stutter, come right back to the middle of the field. Bow his head, get a few yards. Gets his second carry. 19 on his first carry, a couple on his second one, so he has 21 yards on the afternoon. Here comes Dylan Green back in the game. He did work a break. Wide to the left goes number 11. That's Ritter. Brother played here too, Andy Ritter, junior wide receiver from Butte, Montana. In the slot to the left, Delaney split wide. Turn to give it to Green. He's going to cut it back inside. Got his head. So Carroll just running the football. They aren't even looking to throw the ball at all. When you're up 62-12, that's the correct thing to do. So it's 3rd and 8 for Carroll. And I would imagine if they don't get it here on 3rd down, they'll be able to shot a throw. We'll see. Clock continues to roll, thank goodness. 5:04 to go. Way past my nap time, but I'll deal with that. I'll be all right. Ritter and Delaney to the left side. Dylan Green, the lone setback behind JT Linder. And they'll fake it. And there goes Linder on a rollout. Designed quarterback play. He'll get to the end zone. Did he get in? He's close. Touchdown. JT Linder on a 13-yard run. Quarterback keeper just sprints out to the right side. Rolls her into the end zone, and Carroll on the board again. This score comes with 4:37 to play. Quarter four. Stop on the board. Now Winston's been busy, busy, busy man. There's a snap to play. It's on its way. And it is good. Timeout on the field. With 4:37 to play, Carroll 69. College of Idaho 12.
My parents taught us how important it is to take care of one another. My father was an accountant and my mother worked for the school district. Together, they took very good care of our family and our future. Today, I'm a father and a grandfather. It's important to plan for your loved ones so you don't have to worry about their futures. Call or stop by the Brad Schmidt Agency, and together we can build a plan for you and your family. Take care of the next generation.
As a student, as an athlete, it is so important to stay focused.
I maintain my focus just by working my hardest in absolutely everything I do.
When you step on the mat, it's only you and another person, and making healthy choices is the first step.
Depending on what I eat, my nutrition, people I hang out with, not using tobacco.
I don't think I'd be the person I am today if I had used tobacco.
The community follows those teams that are respectful.
I love being a role model for kids all across the state.
I'm focused on a tobacco-free generation.
Return to Nelson Stadium once again when it's been a lot of Carroll and not a lot of Coyotes. Saints have been all over the Yotes here this afternoon. And it really started at the 9:08 mark of quarter number two. At that point, just before that, it was 14-12. It was 7-6 at the end of the first quarter. And Carroll scored with 11:20 to go at the second quarter. But the College of Idaho came right back and scored to make it 14-12 after the mixed second missed extra point. And since then, folks, it's been all Carroll. They have scored the last 55 points in a row. It's 69-12. And Peter Young knows which game to take off. There's Brady on the return. He's had a lot of opportunities, and he's not going anywhere. It's number 29 down there to make the tackle for the Saints. Travis Knoll. Job, Travis, a running back, a junior from Big Fork, Montana. 5'11", 210-pounder. He's a junior. Carroll dresses a lot of players for these home games, and I would venture to say most, if not all of them, have been in the game or are going to get in the game. So Hennessy back brings his team back out, sends two receivers to the left side. College of Idaho continues to play hard here through the end, and we have 4:30 to go. Hennessy's going to fire that football down the left side. Almost picked off. Underthrew it a little bit. Number 27 there, Taylor South for Carroll. Almost came up with an interception. He's a sophomore from East Helena, Montana. So Taylor didn't travel very far to play his college ball. About 4 miles. Isn't that amazing? And the same football team, you have to travel 4 miles to go to college. And you have to travel 2,000. You start. Lost it out. Twin receivers to the right side, one to the left. And it's a handoff straight ahead to Teixeira. Not much going on there. Carroll right there to stack him up, number 94 for the Saints. Kyle Smith in on that tackle, along with number 31. Joined him as well, Eric Dawson. So it is third down and long nine, or third down and 10. And twin receivers to the left side. Hennessy will take the snap, look to throw the football out in the flat. Complete to number 7. He was quickly corralled. Ball's out. but it goes out of bounds, and I think they'll have enough for the first down. The pass was complete, obviously, to number 14. No, excuse me, number 7. That is Levi Ellsbury. Zach Salcido in on the stop for Carroll. Fourth down and a yard, and they'll keep their offense on the field. Carroll, have to stop them right here, and they may do it. Nope, looks like Teixeira is going to pick up the first down with some hard running. He got hit in the backfield, carried a man to the line of scrimmage, and then beyond. So tough running that time, number 51 for the Saints. Kozlowski in on that tackle, but good running that time. Good effort that time, I should say. Continued effort all day by Ryan Teixeira. 3:05 to go. Four-man front for Carroll. Carroll hosting a playoff game next weekend. The opponent to be determined. Ball out and incomplete. Through, in and out of the hands of the intended receiver there. Tight end, number 85, Marcus Lenhart. So second and 10 for the Yotes. Will end their season at 3-7 in conference, 3-8 overall, and begin their offseason work to get ready for 2015-16. A season that definitely will be promising for this young team, made up mainly of sophomores and freshmen. Kudos to the coaching staff for getting this team ready to play and pulling this program together. There's a lot to do beyond just getting players. Restart a program. Pass false, incomplete, thrown behind the intended receiver, Isaac Gonzalez. Coming over on the coverage is Taylor South. So it'll be third down. 69-12 our score. Carroll all over the Yotes. Again, 14-12 was the score with a little over 9 minutes to go in the second quarter before Carroll exploded. Eight straight touchdowns for the Saints without a response from the Coyotes. Fire the football out on the flat left side. It's complete to number 6. That's Diffie. And we got a penalty flag. We may have an illegal block thrown by number 3. He and one of the Carroll players, number 34, having some words. Tucker Johnson for Carroll. But I think number 3, Isaac Gonzalez, had a block in the back. Officials gather, all 5 of them. They're all pointing at flags and pointing at the ground and saying, which way did he go? And where's dinner? And then here comes Coach Van Deest. He's going to give his opinion. So I'm sure they asked for it. They said, Coach, what should we do? He's coming over to tell me. Which they always appreciate. So, yeah. Thanks, Coach. See that? That's what he told him. Okay. Now, they're still talking this. Come on, you guys. It's 69-12. Just spot the football. Let's go on. There we go. It's a holding call against the College of Idaho. And Van Deest says, yes, take it. One thing you never see Mike Van Deest do is wear a coat. He just didn't wear one. He must have been one of those kids in elementary school that playground people were all over every day. Where's your coat, Mike? It's inside. Never wore it. Still doesn't. Yes, folks, it's 69-12 and I'm reaching. All right, 2:32 to go. Three-man front for Carroll. On a third and 18. Hennessy's going to look down the middle of the field. Now he's flushed from the pocket and he's going to run. He'll tuck it and won't pick up the first down. Pretty good job that time by coming up for support. Austin Ybarra along with number 27 for Carroll, Taylor South. So it's fourth down and about 13. And what are you going to do here? You're going to punt the football? 2:15 to go. I think you better. Yeah, they're going to send out their punt team. McLemore, who's been as busy punting the football as Matt Wiest has been with extra points all day, steps back onto the field. And Anthony Clark and Jerem Marinick are going to go back there and return this. So obviously they don't have a second team return man, because these guys are the ones that were always out there. We got a whistle. Yep, delay a game. That, there we go. Well, that's number 4 or 5 this afternoon in the second half. So I just have a hard time figuring that out, because why would you delay the game when you're down by 55 points? I'd be out there snapping the ball as quick as I can, get that clock running. Whatever. All right, here we go. All right, so McLemore, this time we'll set up on his 10-yard line. Rugby punt, gets it away. It's going to hit near midfield. Take a coyote bounce, and it'll die down near the 40-yard line, about the 42, and that's where Carroll will have it for their final possession, leading by 57. 69-12, our score.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Check it out. The 2014 Ford F-150. Looks great, but let's build one for me. I need a 4x4 with plenty of power. Because back here, I'll be pulling my boat. Add some chrome, 18s. Ooh, some fog lamps. Nice. The XLT 4x4. What's this? Just announced, get over $10,000 in total value on F-150, or lease one for $259 a month? Now just gotta choose a color. Ooh, black. The XLT F-150. Better hurry, it all ends soon.
There's always something going on at the Quarry Bar and Grill. Come check out our lunch specials. We make them every day from scratch. Our serving staff is great and will take care of you like family. Located on the Walking Mall.
Carroll College, big afternoon for them offensively. 386 yards on the ground thus far for Carroll. 242 through the air. So, an amazing, amazing afternoon. Over 600 yards of total offense. With one more possession to go here. Which I think will probably be a couple of kneel downs, I hope. I don't see College of Idaho calling timeouts here. Just pray to God there's no delay of games. Nope, Linder's going to go up under center, and they're just going the victory formation and let this one go. They'll have to do that maybe two more times. But a big, big win for Carroll here at home to close out their conference and get ready and set the stage for what's going to be and always is an exciting playoff series. I mean, with Carroll, anything less than the playoffs is really not a good year for them. That's how it's become now with Coach Van Dees. The locals just expect the Saints to be in the playoffs year in and year out. That's so much harder than what it looks like on paper to get there every year, but they seem to. Last year, advancing all the way to the semifinal before losing to Cumberland here at Nelson Stadium in a thriller. And on their way to the first round, round of 16 here next week. Again, the pairings will be announced Sunday night as Linder takes a knee for the second time. It'll probably do it once more. Pairings will be announced Sunday night, so look for that. Carroll website, I'm sure, will have that. And for the Fighting Saints, they will prepare for their first round foe. Again, by finishing with a victory and a number 2 seeding in the NAIA, they have an opportunity to host playoff games all the way up through the semifinal if they can continue to win. And that'll be it. Linder takes a knee. We're down to 7. So that's going to wrap it up. That's another Frontier Conference title for Carroll. They're 14th in 15 years. Congratulations to Mike Van Dees and the Carroll College Fighting Saints. And I'm sure in the future we'll see more of College Idaho as they'll grow for next year. But again, our final from the Nelson Stadium, 69-12. We're going to take a break, come back, and then wrap it up. We'll be back. It's 69-12. We'll be back with the wrap-up after this.
Upgrade. It means your day just got better. That's the idea behind First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. With every purchase, you earn points you can use to upgrade just about any aspect of your life. Even better, rewards come from your world, your neighbors, your favorite local businesses. It's the difference between dining out and dining out in style. Your style. First Rewards World MasterCard from First Interstate Bank. Your style, your rewards.
It's hard to be in college and not be focused.
Being an athlete even helps you become more and more focused.
If I don't stay focused, I fall way behind on schoolwork.
A lot of homework on the bus and in hotel room.
This is one of the most formational times in your life, and so it's important to make healthy choices.
Because people who are tobacco free just do better in school.
I don't use tobacco. I feel like your body is your temple.
I don't think I'd be the person I am today if I had used tobacco products.
I'm focused on a tobacco free generation.
One more time, Carroll College victorious over College of Idaho. 69-12 is the final. And what was a game that was much, much closer through the mid-second quarter. And then from there on, it was Carroll outscoring College of Idaho 55-0. And that started about the 9-minute mark of the second quarter when it was 14-12. Carroll just took off. So touchdowns, a lot of them today. Jordan Pine, senior tailback, 2 touchdowns. Dustin Ranker, senior tailback, 4 touchdowns and 170 plus yards. Over 120 yards for Pine. Mac Roach, great day throwing the football. So all in all, a complete domination for the Saints. Again, playoffs start next week. Carroll will host a playoff game, the quarterfinals, round of 16. So look for that announcement soon, coming up Sunday evening once all the pairings have been announced. But Carroll definitely will retain that number 2 seating. And the only way they can move up to number 1 is if Morningside loses, and they don't have a score on their game today. But Morningside, the only team atop them. But for the Fighting Saints, they lose their first game to Southern Oregon, and they come back and win 9 in a row. And they finish the season 9-1, finish it strong with a victory over College of Idaho.
A resounding victory, 69-12. So that'll wrap it up from Nelson Stadiums. Thanks for staying with us. We look forward to bringing the playoffs starting next week. So come right back. We'll see you in about a full week now, 7 days from now. Tune back in. And we should have some playoff football for you. But until then, from Nelson Stadium, I'm Joe McMahon. 69-12, our final. Have a good evening, everybody.
Before you start your search
for the largest investment in your life, First Community Bank is here.
Pre-qualification is easy. In most cases, it's the same day.
For first-time home buyers and new construction.
Or your home away from home.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Office Solutions, for everything from office supplies, to office machines, to space design, to school supplies, even coffee and dogs. We are part of the largest wholesale buying group of office supplies in the country, which means you get the best of both worlds. National level pricing tied with local level service. Whether you walk in the store, order online, or work with our sales consultants, 360 Office Solutions is your answer. And we deliver smart answers everywhere you turn. 360 Office Solutions.